Ready.
Hello and welcome to Mint Potions Super Smash Brothers Wii U Tournament. It's our second ever Smash Brothers tournament. It's our monthly game tournament for the month of October. Thank you for joining us. Hello everyone in chat. Hey Kayaka, good to see you again. I don't think I've seen you. Where is my studio, says Nostat. Hello, by the way, Nostat. So yeah, where's my opponent? You need to join, you need to join our room. Everything's been set up. I believe everything's been set up. I'm gonna back out just to make absolutely sure of that. Should we like to leave? Yes. So the way this is gonna work is you're gonna join the room that I, that was right. Okay. You're going to go ahead and join the room that I'm going to create now. And our rules are as follows. We're going to play a stock game of two stock and have a time limit of 6 minutes. Those who do not show up in time will be banned. Those who do not, those who stall will forfeit the match. Excuse me, when I said banned, I mean will have their spot forfeited if you join late. So I always pick a random character and then I always kill myself. And we are waiting for people to join. We are running this tournament through a bracket on through the website Challenge, which is what we've been doing for the last few months. Gone are the days when we would run our custom bracket, because this is just faster and easier for you to jump in and join. So that is going to be updated in our stream frame as we go. Let's get to it and say, where is your opponent? Right now, Waka Baka says Lord Cute Things. Hello. Nostat says he's in the Discord. Yes, as per our rules, you do need to join our Discord. The rules say by 2:55. We're starting a few minutes late, so we're definitely not going to punish the punctual, but at the same time, we will honor your participation if you do join us in Discord. Do join us in Discord. And if you're having any issues, you know, I have chat, we have chat right in front of us. Do chat to us through us on Twitch, and we'll get you set up in Discord. Thrown in the bracket and ready to go. So, we are now waiting for people to join the room that that I've created. Once again, I'm not actually going to be playing. I have to be a player to get the game going. I'm just going to jump off the edge for my two stock. A new challenger approaches. This is Nick. This is our friend Nostat. There you are. Good. I'm glad you're the first in, Nostat. I don't think I've seen you since our last tournament. And if I'm wrong and I've seen you around like community gaming and stuff, I apologize for not recognizing you. But yes, I certainly remember you from last Smash tournament, so welcome back. Thank you for coming. AJ Barr, same deal, my friend. I haven't seen you since last Smash game. Cool. Yellow Rello, hello. I remember you, Mr. Rello. You did quite well last tournament. I was not at all expecting you to miss this tournament, but nonetheless, I'm happy to see you. So, let's get going. Yeah, Nathaniel, super cool. Alrighty. So, yeah, go ahead and pick your fighter now, Stad, and Nathaniel. Good. There we go. Go ahead and pick your players, your fighters, gentlemen, and then we'll get started. So yes, to reiterate, the game rules are as follows. We have a stock of two lives with a time limit of 6 minutes, and as soon as we pick stages, it's going to be Omega stages. So, yes. Not sure if I've been here much. The streams usually don't fall into my schedule. Yeah, I know how that feels. Cool. But thank you. Yes, good question. Thank you for wanting to be with us more, Kaika. We appreciate it. Stage, we choose random. Random for the Omega stages. That's my bet. I left that out. I apologize. Cool. Now Stat is ready. Hunting the duck. Nathaniel's hunting duck. Super cool. And, wonder who I'm gonna be. Trying to hang out in the Discord? Yeah, no, we appreciate that, and I appreciate your choice of words. Trying to hang out in the Discord is the right way to phrase it. It's hard to keep up with everybody. You know, we have a great community that we've been building here, it's a lot to follow. We have a bunch of content creators making a bunch of stuff, constantly chatting it up in Discord. I can relate. Cool. So, we go. So, Omega. And random. Okay, so once again, I am just going to jump off the edge. Please do wait for me to do that. Ready, cool. Oops, I'm sorry. I hit the wrong button. Cool. Oops. Alrighty, ready then. I'm going to jump off and kill myself twice in a row in quick succession. Please wait for me to do that. It won't necessarily be game-changing if you don't, but do wait for me, Bayonetta, to just jump off the edge. So there's one. All right, get ready, everybody, in 3, 2, 1, and begin. All right, now start playing as Kirby, hopping straight over Duck Hunt. It's the battle of the two cute characters. Duck Hunt just running around. Not really, not at all. He's just throwing up skeet. I always thought those were frisbees. Nowstead, Duck Hunt, excuse me. Yeah, no, that's our friend Nowstead, yeah. Knocking around Kirby. Or he would be. Kirby's having none of it. Oh, I'm sorry, I got the names wrong. Nowstead's playing Kirby. I apologize. Oh, my goodness. God, I don't want to get his name wrong again. Hit me with the mallet. And even our stage is adorable. How apropos. Nice. Oh, just grabbing him, slapping him, and dancing a little tippy-toe-like on him. Now Stead's being mean with Kirby, and there he goes. Duck Hunt, down to life. Our friend Nathaniel, whoa, but that, my goodness. The mysterious stranger right out of Fallout 3 comes out and shoots and misses Kirby, and Kirby's just right back to jumping on top of him. Oh, so much twirly toes. So much damage through the twirly toes. Oh, I can kill myself by holding Jigglypuff's shield, by the way. It can be used as a countdown. Ooh, that's a cool idea, Kayaka. That's awesome. Can I kill myself that quickly? Because I remember just going into like a stunned mode. And yeah, you need to contact me next. Cool. Nowstead says he's pausing stream. That's a good idea. Yeah, Nowstead, or people who are actually going to be in tournament, feel free to pause the stream so you can play. By all means, it's my job to monitor and commentate on the stream as we're going. Not yours. Feel free to play. Speaking of which, Nowstead still doing some steady, you know, lots and lots of little bits of. Ooh, I believe that was his own bomb. I believe that was Nathaniel's own bomb as Duck Hunt. Kirby consistently doing lots of a little bit of damage really consistently over time. And there he goes. A solid, not even special, just direction A and goes right off the board. Well done. Now Stead advances. Gets 70 coins and, of course, advances in our bracket. Alrighty, so we are playing. I could change the rules of battle, but I will not. So I'm going to stay as Mr. Rando, and then Nowstead and Hunt Duck, go ahead. Nathaniel, please pick your fighters, and we will go from there. We are playing best 2 out of 3, and that'll change when we get to things like the bronze round and the final round, which will be 3 out of 5, but I'm just going to go ahead and check that. Where did Nathaniel go? Yeah, we have... Best out of three, except for the final match and the bronze match, which would be best out of 5. So, Mr. Nathaniel, do rejoin us. Yellarello, can't find Angry Crow. Nathaniel, LOL. Yeah, a new challenger named Nathaniel. Yes, indeed. Yeah, no worries. God knows I'm guilty of all kinds of mistakes, both running and playing in tournaments. So no worries about that, Nathaniel. Now, Stad, if you're listening, Nathaniel is simply choosing a fighter. I'm going to go out on a limb and say it might be Duck Hunt, given the name. And no worries, Lord Cute Things. You forgot best out of 3. No worries. All right now. Cool. No worries at all. None of this falls under the category of stalling or anything like that. You go ahead and take your time. The only thing you can do wrong is be a no-show, and you're certainly here. Can we play off-stream in games to come? If we have enough tournament in which to do that. Right now, we have a time limit of 6 minutes, so we probably wouldn't have time to get full games in. It might slow us down. Alrighty, everybody is ready. We're going to move on, and we're just going to pick those I want. Yes. Alrighty. So, Omega Random Stage. Don't know what fighter I'm going to be this Pokemon I've never seen before. Alright, everybody's ready. Illinois, there we go. I have a stream manager. Yay! Thank you, producer Ben. Alrighty-righty. I am going off the edge. I like your suggestion, Kayaka, and I completely forgot to choose Jigglypuff. All right, so in 3, 2, 1, begin. Now stat is Luigi running right up, and Nathaniel as King Dedede just lobbing bombs at him as he's running. Oh, but Luigi just bounces it back and hits Dedede with his own bomb. That's a powerful attack that nearly broke Luigi's shield in one fell swoop, but no such luck. The shield held, and now it's all up to that edge technique. Or so it was, and they moved on to the middle of the round. Once again, nice cute stage where our big cartoony characters, or at least one big cartoony character, King Dedede. Lots of bombs being thrown, lots of mallets being swung. Malicious mallet swinging. Trying to masticate the other players. Alright, I'm done with my alliteration. And now Stad, running right across. Same strategy as last time. Consistent amounts of lots of little damage. Over time, King Dedede already up to 126 damage, but doesn't seem to be out of control. No one panicking. That's excellent. King Dedede, oh, once again, nearly breaks a shield in one hit, but that weapon's just limited to not break a shield if it's intact. King Dedede does a little bit of damage up front and then swings the hammer. Luigi's just going to lose his shield and be stunned there. King Dedede up to 170 and still not going anywhere. Bombing Luigi. That appears to be Dedede's only ranged attack and seems to be effective. Oh, King Dedede. Bombing him from the air. I didn't even know you could do that. Oh, not quite timed enough to get to the edge. But certainly not out of the fight. Speaking of, does he have any other ranged attacks? He's got a cannon in his mallet. I learn something new every day. Ooh, King Dedede jumping and throwing bombs while Now stat is Luigi, calling him a noob. Well played. Very nice. Winning in quick succession. Well done, gentlemen. Nathaniel lasting longer there than last round. And yes, thank you, gentlemen. So, running the bracket that we have, that is Nowstat, who won 2 out of 3 over Nathaniel. Thank you both for playing, gentlemen. And, who is up next? Rather Wickly. The tournament will go by rather Wickly, says D-Power. Satroke, if I'm pronouncing your name correctly. And anybody correct me if I'm not pronouncing your name right. We are playing all Omega stages, 2 out of 3, until the final round, which is going to be 3 out of 5. And that includes the bronze round, which is also going to be best out of 5. I have to wait for every match. This is going to take forever. That depends on how many participants we have, and I actually don't have that in front of me in our stream frame. So if one of my producers... yes, this is very important. Winners, do not forget to report your winnings in Challenge, in the website. If you report your winnings, that is how we pay you. We have a cash prize. It's there in the ticker, but we do have a cash prize of $125 for first place, $75 for second place, $50 for third place. We are matching the personal winnings to charity. So you can absolutely keep your money, winners, and Mint Potion Studios will donate your, will match the winnings to a charity. We have a couple of charities we're considering right now. We're considering hurricane relief for Puerto Rico and local music education. Nowstad asks, are Michael and Muffle playing? That information I do not have in front of me. If one of our producers can inform me of that and how many people are playing, because Nowstad makes a great point. This tournament's going to go a lot more quickly. We learned a lot from our last tournament. That's why we have a time limit of 6 minutes. However, right now, how long it'll take is going to be determined by how many people we have. So, we only have 17 participants, and some people may not show up. That's a really important point. Some people might not show up. Some people may be late to showing up. I do want to point out, though, that most of the people that I saw here today... Ooh, Anson is up! Excellent. Most of the people I saw here today are our regulars. And absolutely... thank you for the kind words, Satroke. Yeah, we absolutely try and give back. Puerto Rico relief. Yeah, definitely. That's definitely a strong contention, because we're going to have, we're going to be, you know, taking local music education into consideration pretty much, you know, for as long as the studio exists. And we definitely want to make sure we help out the folks in Puerto Rico. You know, last time we were helping out the people down in Houston, helping out, donating for Hurricane Harvey relief. And yes, all of our, as I was saying, all of our, I can see who's playing here. Yes, indeed. Cool. As soon as, yeah, as soon as our next challenger, you have the challenge already. Thank you, Nosedad. Tweet us. Yeah. Tweet us and spread the word, please. Waiting for our next participant. And yeah, as I was saying, all of our, sorry, I got interrupted there with all the good news about, you know, donating to Harvey and chatting with people and stuff like that. We only have 17 participants. It's all our regulars, so they're probably going to be very punctual and responsive. But it is worth noting people might show up, come late. So, right now what we're waiting for, I do not have the answer to that. If that Nosedad, I do not know if this is Mikhail's set. Right now I'm only seeing the people in chat, and yeah, waiting for someone to join. So Anson's in. Yeah. Right now, other than Nosedad and... Oh, Anson is Muffled Kerfuffle. Okay, to answer your question, Nosedad, this is Muffles round. No worries. Right now we're in second round. Yeah. right now this is just our second round. And yes... I don't know what Mikhail's name, or Michael's name, excuse me, if he has one on the Wii Friends list would be. D-Power, are we playing Zombie M? Zombie right now? Not right. Angry Crow is present and in the building. Right now, the only person in the room and on stream, personally, is me. I'm the face of Mint Potion, at least for this stream. Does not show up, then I play Anson Wright. That's a good question. I do not have the bracket in front of me. Right now, with 17 participants, I do not believe that you would be up next, Nosedad. Nosedad, Nathaniel, I think you all are not, playing, simply because we need the next two. One of our producers is off frame here. Who is up next? It is not D-Power. It is, Muffled Kerfuffle, aka Anson. And Nosedad, I believe you are sitting tight, my friend. Ah, indeed. Indeed. Okay, so. No worries. I'm being told that we just upgraded our equipment, which is awesome. You will all notice the improvements immediately. But I will not be able to see the bracket when it's up. So, the... No worries, the listings are here, and I'm certainly not trying to say that anything's going wrong. Au contraire, Baudelaire, we have a lot of improvements. Last time, if you've been with us for a while, you've probably noticed that the stream would go down occasionally. That's absolutely, totally unlikely now with the new equipment that we have, and things are just going to run a lot smoother. So yeah, Mint Potion. Mint Potion is not Angry Crow. At Mint Potion is one of our producers and community manager. Angry Crow is a different entity here at the studio. Michael in Discord. I'm not sure who Michael in Discord is going to be on our Wii Friends list. Excellent. Cool. I now have the bracket technology, folks. Thank you, sir. So. Alrighty then. Michael. Yes, indeed. So Michael is, and thank you for your patience, everybody. I now have the bracket in front of me. Michael, Michael in Discord is who we're waiting for, and I am not sure, to be honest, who, what their name is going to be. So at the tone, the time is 3:29. How much longer we're going to give him remains to be seen. We don't really have a format for, a procedure for latecomers, just because we don't have that many latecomers. Normally, Michael will be playing from here. Sven Stormbeard. Hello, Sven. It's not, been telling us that Michael's not making it. So, oh, Michael is coming. Oh, Michael is playing from the studio. Gotcha. Sounds good. He's going to be switching with D-Power. Okay, aha! I know Michael. Excellent. No, Michael will most definitely be joining us. Michael's a special friend. Michael's a good friend of the studios. And I'm just being told by a producer that right now he's switching with D-Power. So, Anson, Muffled Kerfuffle, you will be playing shortly. Yes, indeed. Aha! We have a new challenger. So, Rel, you are up. So we're going to have a little bit of change. Thank you for your patience, everyone. A little bit of change in the listings. Michael is switching. He's definitely going to be playing. He's actually going to be playing in person. Nostad says RIP to Rel. All right. So thank you for your punctuality, Anson. Rel, no pressure, though. Go ahead and take your time choosing your fighter. We'll get jumped into a random Omega stage, and we'll get right to it. Sven Stormbeard. Yep, Michael is making it. He's just coming later. And for those of you who've been following, Mikhail and Michael are the same person. I wasn't sure about the pronunciation, but I realize now who Michael is, and he is most definitely going to be playing later. The Random God. Yes, indeed. Dun, dun, dun. Rel has left us. I'm sure they just hit B on accident. The matches are number two. They're kind of supposed to be played in that order. Yes, you're most definitely right, Sven Stormbeard. So thank you for your patience. We do understand. Yes, it should be possible to do an earlier match. However, Rel just showed up and then disappeared. So I'm thinking that'd be the best thing to do. Tamaki. Yeah, most definitely. Rel is here. Awesome. Yes. Yes, indeed. Thank you for your patience, Nostad. Okay, so right now we have both Rel and Anson ready, and we're about to jump that in. In the future, we will be able to start different matches to get things going. So, without further ado, playing for fun, says Yellow Rel. Gotcha. You're playing for fun, Yellow Rel, or you believe that... that's what we are, or that's what these fighters are, because right now it's definitely competitive, amongst most people. Alrighty, righty, I'm over the edge once. I am over the edge almost twice. Sorry about that, Rel. And begin. Zero Suit Samus going right after Lucina there. Ooh, that's Rel. Rel is our yellow Zero Suit Samus, and Anson is our red Lucina. Right now, both players being relatively reserved, sort of waiting to see what the other one does, which is always smart. Right now, not a lot of projectiles being thrown. That's something, nor in our first match, which genuinely surprised me. You know, I'm really the type of Smash player who hangs back and starts peppering people with bombs and air while I do plays. As Link, who's got a good plethora of projectile attacks, but nonetheless, you know, that's definitely true for the four characters we've seen so far, and yet both are kind of feeling each other out. Ooh, Lucina takes up to 115 damage, but just isn't out. Even getting knocked pretty decently across the field by a smash attack is just fine. No one's even had to use anything like edge technique. No one's had to use anything. No one's ever really grappled. We're all just sort of feeling each other out, which I think is fascinating, you know, given the fact that a lot of people here... Oh, but Lucina does go out with that one. 120 or so is just too much. And there's Zero Suit Samus flying all over the place. I thought Zero Suit Samus was out, to be perfectly honest. I thought Rel was simply off the board, but that high jump... you're all good, is just saving it. Oh, but can Rel does it again. Zero Suit Samus. Lucina just hanging back, waiting for him to come. Nice, nice, nice. Alrighty, things seem to have picked up a little bit, at least from my end. And we appear to have a nice even fight. Zero Suit Samus is now the one at over 120 damage and is doing just fine. Ooh, I think that would have been decisive. Lucina, if you had landed that charge attack, that would have been it. Zero Suit Samus just would have been off into the corner. Oh, Zero Suit Samus is... I thought for sure that would have been it, but no. Zero Suit Samus is still here, kicking butt and taking names. Or name, I should say. Nice, even keel game so far. And both these players are very well matched as well. Both lightweights relatively fast. Middleweights and nice and fast. But they'll pick up. Right now, the way things are going, I think both players are just tenderizing each other. I don't think we're gonna get anywhere close to the time limit. I think we're both characters are one good smash attack, and there it is, Anson as Lucina, one good smash attack away from knocking Rel down. And now both characters are at one stock. Lucina is down to 97% damage, or up to 97% damage, I have to say. Ooh, that would have been decisive. Oh no, Zerus's Samus is back down to zero. I apologize. And there it is! Rel, a Zero Suit Samus, kicks Lucina right off the match, right off the map, and advances to the next round. All right, good round, everybody. Good job, Rel. I actually thought Anson had that one at first, I must say. So good job coming up from behind. And Yellowrilla says he just jumped in for fun. Very cool. Michael is here for your information. He is in the building. We're going to go ahead. And we do have one more round. Excellent. Angry Crow. I think Michael's going to want to play. If you're interested in playing Angry Crow, that could be arranged. Angry Crow is down there with Yellow Mellow. Yep, Michael's still with Muffle Kerfuffle. And right now Angry Crow is paired up with you, Yellow Rello. Alrighty. Walking right into F-Smash. Yeah. No bombs, my friend. Yeah. Indeed. We always have to do a couple of things on the fly. We always get it done. Anson's choosing their fighter. Rel seems to have backed out momentarily, but they will be considered present until too much more time goes by. 19 viewers. Yes, indeed. What's with the disconnects? That's a good question, Nostad. Right now, disconnects could be... we're always going to have one technical thing after another. After the upgraded equipment, I can tell you that that's going to be measurably less disconnects, thanks to the studio's in-house equipment. We made a big upgrade this week. We actually took last week off and are now coming back strong. And I do believe that this is the second ever stream that we've had with this equipment. Anson, ready to go. Rel, Yellow Rel, that's a good question. Media playback aborted. That's not good. Yellow Rel is Rel. I apologize. You're confused. I do apologize. I thought you were. We have another member of our Discord in whose name is an R, and I thought that was you. I thought I saw that come up. Okay. And yes. Well, you did, Rel. Yes, Yellow Rel. This is best 2 out of 3. So you seem to have dropped out. If you could rejoin us. Right now, that is your appointment. We had to switch yours. We had to move some things around. Yellow Rel, I did not realize you were Rel. Right now, you are playing your second round with Anson. I apologize for the confusion. Why'd you switch? Which is the guy talking? I am not playing. The guy talking, that is me. I am not in the bracket, nor am I on Twitch or Discord right now. You switched because Michael is not here. That's correct. You got moved up to keep the tournament moving. So right now, you are slated to play against Angry Crow, but right now that's at the end of the bracket. So right now you need to play your second match. Excellent. Perfect. With Anson. So... already ready. So, Yellow Rello and Muffle Kerfuffle, right now you are playing your second round of the... game of the round. So, best 2 out of 3, as usual, until we get to the bronze and the final matches, which are going to be best out of 5. It's still going to be... there's going to be a stock of... Still 2, and still going to be an Omega stage, with the exception of any tiebreakers. That's going to be 3 minutes instead of 6, and it's going to be 1 stock instead of 2. But yes, we're going to have 2 stock and 6 minutes until then. Probably gonna.
Is he the young guy there? You think I showed up?
Yes. Yes, indeed. Okay. Alrighty. Let's choose stage. Doot. Doot. Cool. And away. Oh, dun dun dun. Da 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 dun. I didn't realize how long this animation is. It's the only time that's ever happened. Cool. Boom. Alrighty, ready. So, I play Angry Crow. No, no. You're doing dun dun dun. Depower had forfeited. I don't mind waiting for Michael. Okay. Well, oh, we are ready. All right. Make ready, everybody. And here. Same as before. Pac-Man's got to go over the edge. I'm over once. I'm about to go over twice. So, in 3, 2, 1, begin. Ooh, right off the bat, just Mario just spritzing Roy with water. Oh, Roy, one of my favorites. Going back to Smash Brothers Melee on the GameCube. Roy and Marth were just the power hitters. I always loved playing those guys. Oh, well then. I do not know what that is. I do apologize, everybody. We have an error. We have a Wii U error. So right now there's nothing wrong with the stream and there's nothing wrong with our connection. So I do apologize for that. I will remake this this room right now. Create a new room. Change the rules. Make myself a rando. Make sure all the rules are the same. This is due to some Wii U weirdness. Our new stream equipment is awesome. Our network connection, which we upgraded a couple months ago, is awesome. That's a wee bit of Wii U weirdness, and I deeply apologize for that. But that's not going to affect our streams in the future, and frankly, it shouldn't affect our stream for the rest of today. So Anson is back. Yellow Rello, please do. Please do rejoin. Sorry about the disconnection. Problems with the Wii U, that happens. Yes, indeed. Alrighty, so yeah. Just a Wii U thing. That is annoying, but it's not going to stop us. So go ahead, and we'll get right back to it. Alrighty, righty. Dun, dun, dun. No need for the sad emojicons, AJ. Is it Ibarra or just Barra or is it Yabara? Let me know, AJ. Ain't nothing but a Wii U thing. Well, me? No, Wii U. It has been way past 6 minutes. It has been now, Step, but nonetheless, we're going to give our competitors a fighting chance. Indeedy doodle. Well, we are ready. We are ready. And now we go again. So confused about this. This is for you, Michael, says Yellarella. So but that will keep it on for next time. I get to be Ganon. Nice. Nice! I get to be Ganon for a few seconds. When I was a kid playing Ocarina of Time in the 90s, I was just like, oh man, maybe one day you could do that. Maybe you could play as Ganon. Alright. I go off the edge. Once. Dun da da dun. What happened there? It's been decided. You're playing this set. It's been decided. Oh, this ain't legal. LOL. Interesting. Alrighty. I was not expecting that. Okay. Okay. So, the stage was not legal. Gotcha. Already ready. Let's move on then. Omega. Okay, try that one again. Sorry, folks. It's not Liga. Alrighty, Peach! I love Peach! Dun da da dun, da 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 dun. Okay. Cool. I go off the edge here. Alrighty. Going off again in 3, 2, 1, begin! Alright, same characters last time, Roy and Mario, although they did have the opportunity to switch. I really appreciate the good gamesmanship, keeping things exactly the same. Sorry again about that not being a legal stage. Ooh, Roy coming out swinging, literally and figuratively. Mario, Yellowrello's Mario, always responsive, but Roy's just so powerful. Mario's the main man, though. Mario, I have to say, is the character that's got the most finesse that you can get out of. You know, he's one of those characters that you can play as simply or as complexly as you want. And Mario, I think, is my favorite character to watch, especially with someone who's really, really experienced like Yellowrello. But yeah, Anson having none of it, just swinging that sword as much as he can. I think this is going to be nice and tight. I think that damage is... Oh, no sooner do I begin to say I think it's going to be tight. Roy goes off the stage. But Roy's so powerful. I think that Roy's going to get Mario right up into the high damage way before Mario is going to get Roy somewhere that he can just, you know, knock him out the level with a smash attack. But we shall see. Ooh, I think that's the first grab we've seen all game. Nice and theatrical. Ooh, that shield almost went. Oh, Mario goes for a grab himself, but just... Anson just dodges out of the way. Oh, those little fireballs. You're better than that, Yellowrello. Oh, he goes down. Oh, I thought for sure he was going to be up to... Yellowrello is going to be up to his old tricks and get right up on the edge and have us see some of that nice edge technique. Ooh, Mario's bopping him around. Ooh, Roy gets stuck in that long swing animation, you know. The most classic fighting game balancing, which is just the heavier hitters move slower. Roy's no DK, though. You know, these are both still, you know, middle ground characters as far as power and speed. I thought that was it, but no, Roy's back. And 30 damage in one hit. Oh, get away from me, says Yellowrello. There we go. I think another flurry like that, Mario might be up to right around 80, 90 damage. So this could get very close very fast, but no. One good head bop. Yellowrello, as Mario, knocks Roy right out of the stage. Anson is Roy right out of the stage and advances. That is 2 out of 3. Well done, Yellowrello. Yes, indeed. Anson. No, that was Rel. That's the game? Yes, no, that was Rel. Yeah, no, Anson played very well both times. I thought you had it in the beginning of both rounds, I have to say, but Yellowrello does advance. Alrighty, righty then. We're going to switch. Was that the case? AJ Barra says that Nowstead and Rel were going to switch, and that's not what I was being told. No, no, no. You're Angry Crow, right? Let's play a 2 out of 3. No. Right now. Yeah. So who's up next? To keep it nice and simple. Right now, Nick. Nick approaches. Yeah, right now, who's up next? Yeah. Hello. We're trying to figure out who's up next exactly with the changes that we've made. Right now, it appears to be Michael and Muffle Kerfuffle. Cool. Michael's in the building. We now need only to hand this over. I will be back. Move Michael forward. We're going to be doing exactly that now, Stad, both literally and figuratively. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Michael beat Muffle. Muffle must lose. Muffle just lost. Well, we all win now that we have this competition going. Full swing. So yeah, right now, who is up next is the much talked about Michael. Adapter. Dun, 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 dun. I believe you might have to plug that in. The wave probe is not working. Oh, worst comes to worst, you can use... Nope. That is not the right one. Worst comes to worst, my friend, you can use the tablet, which is never pleasant, but at the same time doable. Yeah, exactly. In the meantime, forgive the clutter. One of those ought to work. Okay. Oh my goodness. Good, that only turns this on. Okay. Unfortunately, no. Hi. Oh my goodness. Good eye. Alrighty, we're just getting Michael set up right now. Yes, indeed. Either one, right? Oh, I see.
On. There we go. Hey, we're in there.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello.
Microphone.
Microphone.
This
Michael
is a microphone. There we go. It's popping, people. Sorry for being late.
Michael, no. Whoa. I do believe. Oh, good. That went through.
Oh, you have to press two-player.
Oh, my...
So you gotta go
yes,
back.
Indeed. Excuse us now, Stad. I had what psychiatrists call a brain fart, and I need to. Actually, you can't just hit start.
Unless you go out and then.
Yeah. No, I'm gonna have to leave this room. So now, Stad, you're gonna have to rejoin us in a quick sec, because now that Michael is here, we need to remake the room to have two local players.
Sorry about that, guys.
No worries. Yeah. So making the room, create a room. Oops. Nope, I need to back out and go to the two-player local. There we go.
It is. Perfect.
I do want to create a room. And that will have the same rules. Let me check that really quickly. Stock 2. Sorry about that.
No problem.
Stock 2. And yes, indeedy doodle.
6 minutes.
Cool. Cool.
Yes, indeedy doodle. Let's start saying that.
Yeah. Nick approaches.
Nick.
Cool.
For the main.
Yeah.
Good to go.
Mr. Pitt.
So I missed most of the tournament. How's it been going so far?
Oh, you haven't missed most of it. We've only gotten through the first two pairings. Alrighty, awesome. You ready, sir?
I am ready.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Why two player? Because our next participant, Michael, is playing locally. He's
Hello.
He is here. And in order to there's no viewing function for this mm-hmm. game, so in order to host a tournament, the caster actually plays and then jumps off the edge, as you've been seeing. So without further ado...
Because
Nintendo. Can literally just pick one player, don't hit gamepad. No, yeah.
Oh, interesting.
Cool. Dun, dun, dun. Yeah. Oh!
Oh, I guess.
Oh, God. Then now, said Nathaniel, the only ones who played so far. We had Nowstad, Yellowrello, Anson... excuse me one second to get these guys going. I am off. Half of my lives are gone. Here goes the next one. All right, everybody, get ready in 3, 2, 1, begin. Michael as Pitt coming up against Nowstad is Kirby once again. Green Kirby. Beginning to see a pattern here. yeah, Nowstad, a tried and true strategy that's been totally totally effective and fun to watch so far, which is lots of little damage very consistently. Pitt,
oh,
a little bit heavier than Kirby, certainly. Delayed, you're not having a technical issue, are you?
No, it's just Nintendo.
Just Nintendo. Nintendo's always there to be the one that you blame. Yes, indeed.
He's too short.
And he's just, Nowstead's just very, very quick to dodge. You know, Nowstead certainly knows what he's doing as far as smash and especially as far as Kirby. However, you're no slouch yourself. Last I checked, this damage, it was 48 to 15 damage, and it was 48 to 55. So as much as he knows what he's doing, so do you, Michael, and this is going to be a good match. Oh, I thought for sure we were going to see Kirby turn into a brick. And just smack you around, but no, not quite. Not a lot of, not a lot of that I realize is, you know, the smash attacks are like, you know, the down bees, out of Nowstead, which is really cool, because he's fighting a lot faster. You know, that's one thing Kirby does. Kirby floats very and jumps very slowly, but he strikes so fast. Oh, man. Nice and neat. Neatly matched with the damage. Just no sooner do I say it that Nowstead knocks Michael out of the map. You've got wings too. You think you just fly back in, but no, not quite. Once again, I'm like and down B, but no, I'm quite the noob at this game, and I stick to the power moves even for the, you know, lighter, flightier characters. Oh my God, you gotta grab him and smack him around right by the edge, huh? Oh, nice. Good edge technique. It's just, you know, recovering into an attack. That's very good. Oh, now he goes. Ooh, kneed him to the face. Took a Kirby to the knee. Oh, nice. Oh, good catch. I was like, wow, I did not see Nowstead making that kind of mistake, but totally caught himself. There we go. Oh, ooh, was that a? Did you throw him off the edge?
I did throw him.
That was incredibly cinematic. You just picked up that ball and threw him off the edge. Well played, Michael. But right now, it's still anyone's game. You know, Pit doesn't have that much damage, and Nowstead's certainly capable of, just as capable of winning as you are right now.
Ooh.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. Oof. Mm.
Ooh, ooh,
ooh. Man, Nowstead having none of that. So much damage with the Twinkle Toes. So pretty. So lethal. Oh, man's got wings. Man's got wings. And edge technique. Nice. Good. Recovered into an attack. Perfect. Nice. Oh, that's right. Those arrows that you can steer. Oh, horrifying. Slow. But very cool. Oh, there he goes. Bounce him up in the air like a beach ball. Ooh, he is short. He dodges so easily. He just went right under you. Well, he has been all match. Ooh. Nice.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, Nowstead. Just running around. Just nickel and diming you with damage. I do have to say, you're doing extremely well last time. Just about dead even. This is the closest we've come to a timeout, but I don't think that it's going to happen. I think Nowstead, still in it. Still in it. Excellent. Dodge right under that yet again.
Jeez.
And that's
that
it.
Close.
That is the end of the first game. Nowstead, as Signature Green Kirby, goes the next one. Signature Green Kirbs.
GG's.
Alrighty then. Yeah, good game, everybody. You can change the rules, but we are not. Just go ahead and pick your fighters, everybody.
Tisk tisk.
Tisk tisk tisk. It was nice and close, though. Oh, interesting.
It was close.
Cool. Doot doot. Doot doot. Yeah.
I like that. That's how I nice. Crack my fingers. Really
yeah.
Late.
Cool. We are ready. Wow. Such a flurry. Oh. Alrighty. As always.
Good old Kirby.
As always, I go down. Oh, don't begin yet.
Ah, man. That was my fault.
Oh.
Let's start over. Sorry
dun,
about that.
Dun, dun, dun.
I got. I was too ready.
Yeah. Too ready. Cool. Thank you for your patience, everyone.
My me.
Yeah. Excellent. Oops, let me just... Excellent. Yeah. No, jumping the gun is bound to happen. that happened last time, and last time we just sort of let it ride because it was our first time running this game in a tournament. But now we're definitely going to be starting over if that happens again. But yeah, no worries, and let's get to it. Let me just let Mr. Pac-Man go right over the edge here. And we will begin in 3, 2, sorry if I'm almost hitting you now, instead, 1, and begin! Ooh, picking them up.
Boy, the combos, the
nice.
Combos!
Nice, the combos, oh the combos! Can they get back from that far? Oh, they can, and they both recover with, well, now instead recovers with an attack. I did not realize Cloud could jump like that, that's awesome. Okay, pace seems to have picked up a little bit. Both players. I like it. They're feeding off each other. One goes fast, the other goes faster. That's good. Wow. Cloud's a character you can literally knock on his butt. That's funny. Ooh, that's playing risky. Defensive, playing very smart. Cloud getting knocked around. Then again, he did that giant sword, so I don't think he has to... Boom. I don't think he has to worry that much. Ooh. Nosedtab. Up to 100 damage already. Dealing that damage. Oh, that horrifying charging thing, whatever that may be. Oh, Clouds.
Oh, no.
Oh, there it is. The first Kirby block of the game. First Kirby down B of the game, excuse me. And that's it. That was his first stock gun. That's excellent. I thought I was being weird talking it up, just like, no, really, I thought that was going to happen. I thought that would be cool. Just totally effective. That's awesome. Noob moves, they win games sometimes. What can I say?
Is this true?
Oh. That character is really short. Like, I was like, Nosedtab really is just really good and quick to dodge and all that good stuff. But seriously, that character is so short, he's just so easy to kick over. To go, oh, hey. Speaking of which, he stops to attack. Nosedtab gets knocked off the level. Out of the level. Ugh. Twinkle toesing right back. Telling him how he feels about that.
Oh, come on, man.
Oh, just short.
Oh, that's rough.
Just short.
That is rough.
Well, good games. Okay. It's okay. Good games. Yeah, good
was late
everybody.
For nothing.
Well played, Nosedtab. Cool. Nosedtab advances again.
Good job.
Dun, dun, dun. So we're going to go ahead and back out of this so we can go back to
I think you could just...
The one player.
Okay.
Yeah,
I didn't know. You could probably just knock me out, but...
Gotcha.
That worked.
Gotcha.
Cool.
Well, this might be an unnecessary step, but...
Stick around for a bit.
It's not going to take very much time at all. What a rookie. Calling you noob, man. Okay, so yes, right now, oops, sorry about that. I don't want Bayonetta, I want some random person. So let's see who's up next. Who's up next is going to be Kayaka and Sven Stormbeard. All righty then. Make sure my rules are the same. Yeah, they should be. They've been the same every other time. Yeah. Well, the rules are good. Ah. Steve. That's my name. Can people still join? I do not believe so. But that's a question for the producers. Is joining still a possibility? I'm inclined to say no, but we shall see. Yo, hello, Kayaka. Named Kayaka. Cool. Kayaka and Sven. Go ahead and choose your fighters, people. We will get going. Without further ado...
Kayaka's meme is freaking me out.
Kayaka's scary, what can I say? Is Steve Sven Stormbeard? It appears so. Since you are Kayaka, that must be true. Process of elimination. Ah, yes. Yes, indeed. Dun 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 dun. Boom.
What is that? Is that like a mustache? Like, what is that knee?
Oh, I think that's... Oh, that's
like
a
sunglasses.
Super,
it's like
that's
sunglasses.
That's a super
like all
deep
the way down
scowl,
it.
Like down like your upper lip, and then with these scary shades. Yeah.
I'm so
Cannot join. Okay, thank you for the answer. We cannot join right now. So, I go off the edge. There's only room for one Pokemon, and I want Mewtwo to have it. What can I say? And please get ready in 3, 2, 1, begin. Gaika Zelda going after Sven. Wow, that almost got fully charged. I was like, that was not expected. But Mewtwo, forget how big that character is. Mewtwo's a big old Pokemon. Still charging stuff up. That's a brazen move. Is, you know, very quick last second charge ups. You know, that's something you see a lot with like Samus and things like that. Very interesting way to play. Zelda does not get a lot of play.
You don't,
yeah,
don't see a lot of Zelda.
I'm sorry?
Don't see a lot of Zelda.
No, indeed. So. I keep seeing, like, what are these cool attacks? Was that a giant gem? Is that a recovery? Wow, that's awesome. Because you just don't see a lot of her. And who is that big guy who came out of nowhere? That guy with the giant sword. You're not a Wind Waker, I believe. Oh. Nice. Well, she's certainly not letting that guy do all of her fighting for her. Because right now the damage level is pretty even set. Nice. Sven recovers, ooh, and drops off to attack and jumps up over the edge. Good edge technique.
This is some...
No, I thought... Oh, my goodness, Zelda.
Good Zelda player here.
Yeah, no, that's very
that.
Good. Very good recovery. That's awesome. You made an attack from below the level in midair and then totally got to the edge and recovered. Well done. Yeah. Mewtwo playing well as well. Lots of really cool cinematic attacks, just like that one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Kaika is almost definitely going to get back up to the edge, and there he goes.
Oh, boy.
Oh, but Mewtwo almost doesn't. Mewtwo, oh, look at that edge technique. Kaika just bopping him around, but they both get back up to the edge.
That was
I didn't think that was possible for either of these characters. Well done, everybody. All right, yeah, no, it's still anyone's game. They're both perfect. Zelda's
covered from anywhere, basically.
Scotty is just beaming Kayak all over the place. I have no idea. I didn't know Zelda could do that, in all seriousness. That's awesome.
That's it.
Yeah, that's it. Nope, Sven, well done. Just bopping around Kayak as Mewtwo. As Zelda, excuse me. Did not realize that Mewtwo is that powerful. That's awesome. Oh
nice.
No sooner do I say it.
Got the JV2.
Taking zero damage.
Good JV2.
Yeah. That Kaika as Zelda advances. That is cool. Alrighty righty. That is round one. Well done, Sven. Well done, Kaika. I had so much fun, I want to do that again. Excellent. Oh, and it never came up, but I do think it's worth mentioning. You're absolutely not required to keep the same player, for those of you who are joining us for the first time. You know, because as I said, it's mostly our regulars from Discord and from community gaming, but also the last tournament. But we do have a couple new people. You are not at all obliged to choose the same fighter round over round. So I don't think anybody has been hung up on that so far, but it's worth mentioning for the few people who are new to us. Thank you for joining us, by the way, and have yet to fight.
I should have stayed my same character.
Ah, no worries. Alrighty.
Next time.
Ba-ba-ba. No, you're not Omega. Now you're Omega. The Blue Falcon. Cool. I hope we've all seen as many Falcon Punch memes as I have, because they're just so good.
Classic.
I feel like I should be paying someone on the internet somewhere for those. Falco's got to go off the edge. Falco goes off the edge. Oh, that's good gamesmanship, getting right to the edge. We never require that, because we don't want to micromanage people. And 3, 2, 1, begin. But that's great gamesmanship. Thank you. Oh, Mewtwo. Mewtwo charging up. With almost no room to do so. That's awesome. As our first Mii character, I think, in the last two Smash tournaments we've had. Michael's right. That's very interesting.
Yeah, it's using a lot of underused characters.
Yeah, it's very cool. Yeah. I mean, last tournament, I'm not very deep into the competitive scene myself. Being just the one who casts all the tournaments we have here, I was just like, wow, Bayonetta, no one plays Bayonetta. Yo, Rella just mopped the floor with everybody. I was like, okay, and then I kept the first round I saw Bayonetta, and then she kept reappearing, and I was like, okay, yeah. No, that's dope. Yeah,
Bayonetta's OP.
Excellent. Well, people still manage to play competitively against Bayonetta, so that just means we have that many good players giving us good rounds. That's dope.
It's good variety.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And you still see the classics. You still see Mario and Kirby, as we've seen all the time with Nausted and Yellow Rella. Ooh. I am happy to see Mewtwo, who, again, I've never seen before last round.
Interesting.
Yes, indeedy doodle. Oh, is he going to make it? Oh, just...
That's the worst way to go.
Just a split second of... Kaika! That's fascinating.
What a turn of events.
Man of principle. That's an even match. Look at that. That's super cool. Did not see that coming. That's fascinating. You're certainly not obliged to do that to anybody. That's great gamesmanship, Kaika. That's a fascinating way to do things, Kaika. That's awesome. Yeah, both players are dead matched at 24 and 24 damage. After that, that's awesome. Excellent. All right, there are the projectile attacks. Before, earlier in the tournament, and I think it was simply because we were so early in the tournament, both players were really just feeling each other out. Just kind of, you know, no one was using their ranged attacks, and no one was, you know, charging their attacks or stuff like that. Both players were just sort of walking up and sort of shaking hands the Smash Brothers way, seeing what's up with each other, you know?
Yeah, you gotta play it smart.
Yes,
fill it out.
Yes, indeed. So yeah, it looks like our Citruk and Spire are going to be our next, matchup. Super cool.
Yeah, I'm sure this is tough because you know, Mii Fighter doesn't get played a lot, so it's like a lot of moves you're not even sure what to.
Absolutely.
How to fix it.
Right. I honestly don't even know how to commentate on it properly. You know, it's just like, oh man, didn't dodge underneath that attack. Wait a minute, they're not as short as like Pikachu.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. He's evidently got Mega Man's arm cannon and Bruce Lee's Kareem Abdul-Jabbar's tracksuit from that very good Bruce Lee movie.
Game of Death?
Game of Death! Thank you, Michael! Super awesome! Oh, and there goes Kaika! Excellent!
There it is.
Super cool. Played super well. Awesome gamesmanship. Kaika, that's awesome. Oh, that's not a puppy dog face.
Oh, it's one eye. There it is.
That's cool.
That makes sense.
Well done, everyone. Good game. That's awesome. Sven, I thought, to be the brutal truth, I thought Kaika had that one, Sven. I really appreciate that slow and steady move through. That was dope. That is our second round. Kaika and Sven. So we go on one more. Super dope. That's not Omega. That's Omega. Yeah, no, you both did super well. No, that was awesome. Oh, Pikachu.
Pikachu.
Excellent. So good.
Thank you.
Yeah, I love how no matter how old you get, there's always something on TV or in movies that people always try and do imitations of. When I was a kid, it was always Pikachu. So that was deeply nostalgic for me. Thank you for that, Michael. And then it was Borat in high school. And now it's King of the Hill.
Borat.
Now it's King of the Hill. Now
yeah,
we're
it's
all
weird.
Older.
It came all back around.
Yeah. We're just like, okay, we missed the 90s. What's everyone watching on Netflix? Well, the same thing we did on Fox.
Exactly.
Yeah.
King of the Hill, Rick and Morty, a lot of Rick and Morty.
Oh, my God. So good. All right. As always, everyone, I go off the edge. Ooh, Kaika back as Zelda. That's exciting. All right, everybody, please get ready. 3, 2, 1... Begin. Oh my god, that was scary. Zelda just sort of blinked out of existence, and I was like, well, that's gonna be bad. Mewtwo. Oh, Mewtwo doing some damage right up front. Like, once again.
A lot of spacing happening.
Yeah. Sven especially, but both players are a little bit more reserved now. Or rather, Sven being as reserved as he was. To great effect last game, I was like, okay, that's pretty cool. And then all of a sudden, he wins. He just smashed that little me character right out of the level.
Pun intended.
That's a cool... Thank you. That's a dope grab. That was very cinematic. Yeah. Oh, Mewtwo's got that. Didn't even have to grab the edge. Look at that.
Oh!
Look at that. That was
barely
awesome.
Barely had time to process that.
Yeah, right? I thought that was cool. I saw the that Phantom Warrior that Zelda cast, and I was just like, okay, no, that didn't do that much, and then I realized that was not Zelda. And here we go. Right at the edge. Ooh, that's dangerous. That's a grab waiting to happen. Kaika being there at the edge, waiting for Mewtwo to come.
Yeah, Kaika throwing out the Phantom Guardian. Very risky move, but it's working out so far.
Yeah.
There's a lot of ending lag on that move.
Oh, yeah.
You can get hit pretty easy, but...
Oh, yeah. Once again... Managing. Oh, look at that. Mewtwo recovers into an attack. Oh. Once again, Zelda playing right at the edge, and there it is. Zelda, I didn't even think she needed to grab the edge then, but she certainly did. Yellowrella, who's playing next, is going to be Citroke and Spire. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Cool. So Zelda creeping up in damage there, but it's absolutely anyone's game. It's a good solid matchup so far. Very professional. I like it. Very even.
Yeah, a lot of back and forth.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Most definitely. Which is good. You want them close. You never want them one-sided, you know? It can be cinematic watching someone just getting spanked around and, yeah, you know, thrown off the level, but it's not a good game. No. Oh!
Just tossing out up those nowhere. Up-Bs like nothing.
Right? Oh, Mewtwo playing a little bit more defensively. Blocking everything, anticipating Zelda a little bit. I saw it sliding up to a shield.
Ooh. Got a little excited with that Shadow Ball.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah, this is very okay. Tough. It's
yeah, no, it's definitely closer. It's not our longest game, but it's certainly feeling like it because it's nice and close.
Oh,
Zelda! Oh man, that was excellent.
That was close.
That was awesome. Good game, everybody. Alrighty, righty, man, Kayaka. I thought Sven had that one. I thought everything reserved. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But no, Kayaka advances. Good job, both of you. Kayaka, congratulations.
I'm gonna tag out here for a sec.
Sounds good. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Good reminder. Be sure and report your winnings. Those of you who do get first, second, and third, that is how we will pay you. Your cash prize. First prize being $125, second prize being $75, and third prize being $50. You will get bags of pennies in the mail. That's how we're paying. No, we're going to PayPal you the money. Yes. I assume we have a correction here. Gotcha. I do. We've had a change. We have a correction. Sorry about that, everyone. It's not going to be Citroke and Spire like I've been saying. It is going to be Matt H. and BryGuy92. Okay, so a little bit of last minute alteration. We're doing almost nothing on the fly anymore, barring this change, the one before, where we had Yellowrella playing in place of Michael. But yeah, thank you for bearing with us. And as soon as those players join, we'll be getting right back into it. No, they played 3 out of 3. Yep. So you are up. Matt H., everybody, much like our friend Michael, is playing locally. So, BryGuy92. That's why. You got to play with the pad.
That's cool.
You cool? Yeah. Sounds good to me. Cool. So yeah, so you're no longer going to be up against Rando Cardrizian, whoever's going to be playing.
Rando Cardrizian.
I love Cards Against Humanity. I apologize for nothing. Can you have your 125 in Bitcoin? You know, I think that might be possible, Kayaka. That's funny. And that's very brazen of you, calling yourself a winner now. That'd be funny in Bitcoin. Well, what does that come out to in Bitcoin? That'd probably be some interestingly odd number. Do just have me at a loss round one. I get my charger in the meantime. Oh, I gotcha. Yep. Yeah, yeah. Do come. Yeah, yeah. Do whatever you need to. Make yourself ready. Sven Stormbeer. If only Mewtwo had a hitbox on his uppy like Zelda, he'd still obviously be better, but I personally struggle against her. Gotcha.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yellowrella, good question. Right now, it's gonna be Kayaka. That depends on this game. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Okay, we got Citroke.
Absolutely. Citroke. Hello, Citroke.
So, are we ready to go?
He's gonna choose his fighter, and then you're gonna hit the plus button and choose a stage.
Okay.
Yes, indeed. Kayaka and Yellowrella, you are after this one. Thank you for asking. Yeah.
Still picking.
Oh, Yoshi. I love how you play Yoshi.
I know. I love how I play Yoshi, too. Come on, Cetrock. When in doubt, hit the random button.
I think it's lag. I think everybody here is experienced enough to know who they want to play and why. And I'm convinced that that's network lag.
I'm going to get owned.
Have them play next? Yeah. That is what the listings say. Yeah, so Kayaka and Yellow Rello, you will be playing after. Well, Matt H. and BradGuy92 are going to be playing right now. After that, we're going to go not to Kayaka and Yellow Rello. We're going to go to Zombie and AJ.
Should I just hit ready to fight?
No, we have to wait for. Well, you'll just be waiting after you choose the stage.
That's what I'm saying.
That doesn't make a difference. Right now.
I'll beat up on the punching bag.
Beat up on the punching bag. Cool. Yep. Omega. Perfect. So did Bri lose? Only if he, no, he's still there in the, choosing the fighter menu. He has not counted as a loss yet. Only if he like drops out. Is that Braga? Yeah. Yes. Braga Matt H.
Are we wrong?
Whoops daisies. Oh. Sorry about that.
We're wrong.
That was Cetrock that joined us, even though the bracket says.
Do we
else.
Create a room?
Yes.
Okay.
And then all the rules will be the same, so now that you're here, you'll be fine. Cool.
Okay.
Cool. Cool. Otomaki, that's what happened. That's right. Right. Tomaki's not here. Okay. So the bracket has not been updated. Playoff stream. I do not recommend playing off stream because of how much more quickly these games can be going than normal. Yes, indeed. So, we are waiting on Cetrock, not Bri Guy. So the bracket is not
you mean
been updated.
Bri Guy, not Cetrock. We're waiting on Bri Guy, right?
Oh, that's what I was saying and what was corrected.
We had Cetrock in the room.
Gotcha. Oh, I see what you're saying now. Okay.
So we are battling Bri Guy.
Correct. So you are battling Bri Guy. Okay. And that's who I thought was in the room, but was not.
No.
Okay.
Bri Guy, you are being called to the stage.
Yes, indeed you do. We don't have a set time for a no-show or anything like that, but if you take an undue amount of time, then you will not be fighting. So yeah, calling all Bri Guy 92s out there. Yes, indeed. Reset my mod pack. Okay, cool. Can Spire fan make it? That's a good question. Cool.
Why is Cetrock joining again?
Yeah, that was my confusion at first. So
not now.
Clarify that. Let's make sure. Alrighty, righty then. Right now, we are waiting for Spirefan. You and I are going to play right now to fill time. So, Satrok, thank you for being prompt. You and Spirefan are who is actually up next. As far as the tournament goes. So right now, we're just going to... Matt and I are going to play for fun to fill time. So go ahead and hit A for not now. I am going to dive right in. Excuse me? Yeah. We should be able to play online right now. So go ahead and hit no. And it should be fine.
No, because we're in one player.
We're in one player. Never mind. For sure I could just hit start. Okay. So yeah, go ahead and leave. Satrok, thank you again for being so prompt.
Local match.
We're going to wait for Spirefan. Spirefan's having a specific technical issue that we know is going to be fixed really quickly. So we're just going to play not until one of us wins. We're just going to play for fun. 6 minutes, he says. Sounds good to me. Let's do it. Cool. All right. Sounds good to me. Away I go. I'll get back here. No. Not gonna put me to sleep. Oh my god. I just said you're not gonna do that. What'd you put on my head? What'd you do to me? Come on.
No, I wasn't touching you. No. I thought I was up on you. That's fine. That's fine. We'll just do Slapfest 2017.
Slapfest 2017. I miss GoldenEye. I miss playing Slappers.
Jigglypuff.
Oh.
Why?
Ha! This is my living room. Oh, I said it's mine. Mine. Mm-hmm. Cool. Oh, that's not cool. That's cool.
Oh, shit, I rolled right into that.
Yeah, you did. Oh! I think that changes when you're on the edge. Because, like, I was just like, oh, no, I'm going right into that. Oh, come here. There we go.
Oh, you got me.
Yes!
You got me. That's a puff.
Yes! Done.
Sorry, I call that the Harvey Weinstein stare. It's the Harvey Weinstein stare.
Oh my god. That is funny. Alright, everybody.
Are we doing? Are we going?
Spirefan.
What are we doing?
It appears we are backing out, so we're going to go ahead and go back to online. And make room for one player.
I'm not playing, right?
No. No, right now, Spirefan, it appears, is not going to be able to join us. So right now, we are going to the top of round two. So the bracket is now accurate again. So it's Zombie 117 and AJ Ibarra, if you're looking at the bracket. And I'm not sure who those people are on our Wii friends list, but we shall see. But yes, for when you are looking at the challenge bracket, Zombie 117, AJ Ibarra, thank you, sir. Are next. Cool. Alrighty, ready. Yeah. That's correct. Now, Stad. Oh, no. No, no, no. I mean, till the now, Stad. Yeah. So here in chat, D-Power 7, one of our producers is telling me that. Yeah, now said Matt H will be after Zombie and AJ. Okay. Okay. That's 10 minutes away and we can't find my friends. So, yeah, sorry about that, Spire fan. Sorry about that. They don't play. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. So, yeah, our bracket on Challenge is now totally accurate. Absolutely, positively. Yes, indeed. Yeah, thank you for being so understanding about that. Oh, AJ, hello. Thank you for being so understanding about that, Spire fan. We are going to have to move on. We really appreciate you being so cool about it. Definitely. Yes, and yeah. So, yes, we're going to be going in top-down order, you know, the numbered order of round two on Challenge. So, Zombie 117 followed by Matt H. and Citruk. Yoshi dies super late. Can you get grabbed by me when you're at 86? Interesting. That's a good question, Kaika. Indeedy do. So, Mr. Zombie, being called to the stage. Zombie 117 to the main stage. Don't forget your clear shoes. Yeah, go accept Drew 22. That's Zombie. Okay. Thank you for letting us know. Sounds good. His phone's messing, yo. Let's do it. We take those. You see all around two winners. Says Citroke. Yes, indeed. If you win. If you win. Okay. Oh, that's right. I have to back out. Gotcha. Cool. So, what we need to do is add that man as a friend. Add Zombie as a friend. So, when I heard that... Cool. So, oh, I don't need to do this. What am I doing? And that'll be just fine. But in the meantime... In the moment of the meantime. Friends list. What do you mean I can't go home? Okay, at the back end of this game to add our friend Zombie. So Zombie is here. For those of you who are worried about him being a no-show, that is not an issue. What we're doing now... Why can't I go back? Cool. Why on earth can I not get to my friends list? There we go. There we go. Do. View. Hello. Accept. Yes. Alrighty. Cool. So this type of thing is always going to be is always going to happen every once in a while, and it's always going to be okay, which is if you show up on time, we could absolutely include you in the tournament. Like, if you get in contact with us on Discord in time, we can do things like take a minute to add you as a friend so you can participate in the tournament. So stuff like that never counts as a no-show. So Zombie117, you are absolutely going to be good to go. Forgive that delay. We're zooming in on me to be funny, as we did with Matt. So we're not going to have anything like latency like that. Oops. What's this? With friends. There we go. One player. Create that room, yo. Playing for glory. We're all playing for glory. Okay. So. AJ, Drew, come on in. The water is fine. We're adding him, unfortunately. That's funny.
Those pizzas?
Oh, they're candy corn colored Masonic eyes. Hello, Zombie117. Cool. Aha, and AJ. Awesome. Cool. Go ahead and pick your fighters, everybody. Dun 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 dun. Bum, 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 bum. Choosing fighter, choosing stage. Cool. As soon as our friend Zombie117 chooses that, we'll be good to go. Alrighty. He's ready. Alrighty. Do-do-do. If you can hit the foe with a full blade, the move is a meteor effect. Cool. And away we go. All right, as always, I'm going to jump off the edge. Thank you for the good gamesmanship, AJ, going off. I might hit you on accident. And I'm going down in 3, 2, 1, begin. Yoshi charging right out. Bayonetta playing defensively because they have to. Bayonetta knocking people around like crazy. Just as floaty as Yoshi can be, for as fast as he is, he's being a little floaty jump through the air, and Bayonetta just meeting him every step of the way. Oh, I love that egg shield. Always have. I wonder if we're going to see Yoshi eat and poop Bayonetta off the edge of the screen. Off the edge of the level. Always satisfying. That's the coolest, most satisfying dodge I've seen in this game. I did not remember Bayonetta did that. That's too cool. Right now, both seem pretty evenly matched. I can, for as different as the damage levels are, I can tell that both these characters are perfectly capable of recovering. Wow, no sooner do I say it. AJ, as Bayonetta, as you were talking about with Michael, very powerful character, just runs Yoshi right off the map. I don't think Zombie's going to have any of it. I don't think our friend Drew is going to let that happen. Oh! No sooner do I say it. Well played, Yoshi. I thought in the beginning, it could go anyone's way, and that was awesome. You were running around playing aggressively. I saw that big push, that big jump slide in the beginning when you were running around, being the fast-like character that you are, and that was excellent. But Bayonetta, that was exceptional. Well done. Let's do it again. Yeah. The same city. Ha! Alrighty then. Oops. Oops. Super cool. And let's do that. Omega stage. And, me sword fighter. Yeah, interesting. Cool. As always, I go off the edge, and I apologize if I hit you on the way down. Thank you for the consistent good gamesmanship, everybody, where both players go to the edges. And in 3, 2, 1, and away they go. Ooh, Ness, being the little fast character who plays all aggressively. Bayonetta, a little bit less defensive, but just as considered as ever. Yeah, I think that's the word for it. I think players are definitely warming up to each other. We're seeing a lot less sort of, you know, exploratory, you know, attacks and stuff like that. Players are more aggressive now, which is good. I can't even see him. That's exactly how Bayonetta get the ring out against Drew both times. That is super cool. Excellent. Cool. Awesome. Super cool. Oh, once again, already. I look away to do some admin for a couple seconds, and Bayonetta has just high kicked already off screen another life out of. Oh man, that's too cool. Yeah, well done, Drew. But AJ, that was exceptional. You know, and I do like giving praise where it's due. But Zombie, you know, nothing against you, my friend. That was really well played, and for both of those characters, both as Yoshi, who's really hard to play really well. You know, like I was saying before, Mario's character you see a lot of finesse with. That's true for Yoshi as well. And I think Yoshi's actually a lot harder to play because he's so short range. So I thought that was really an interesting choice, and you played Yoshi really well. But that was just way cool, way well done with Bayonetta, AJ. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed, you do.
The return of Matt Hole.
Yeah.
Am I playing with controller or the
pad? Whichever you prefer. If you want to use that one, we can back it out.
Alright. Yeah. Oh, no, we were already good, right? Because we had one player up.
Yeah. No, I was just saying we would have to back out if you wanted to use the pad.
I'm good.
I hate that so much, Oz. Think
I'm
of
good. Alright, who's up?
Who's up? You're up. You are against. You and Satroke. Satroke 420.
Satroke.
Sitok. I feel like you're a bad guy from Metal Gear every time I see your name, Satroke. Satroke has always been really responsive, so we're waiting on him, but I don't think we'll be waiting long. And Yoshi again, like I was just saying with Drew, where that's an interesting choice. You know, Yoshi's hard to be good with. So short-ranged, fast, but not like crazy fast, you know. I thought Ness was a good follow-up.
His hitboxes are nice and big.
That's an excellent point that I did not... Well, I was considering, I was just like, wow, people were really deep into fighting games. Just see hitboxes. And that's fascinating. I don't know that much about hitboxes, of these characters.
He has super armor on recovery.
Really?
He's a dinosaur.
It's true. He is a dang dinosaur.
Satroke, we're waiting on you.
Satroke to the main stage where we...
Setrock.
We've got Setrock. Oh, my bad. Set rock. He rocks the set. What can I say?
Set rock. Where are we at in the brackets now?
We are here. So we're at number 10, and we're under round 2. So the brackets have been updated, and we're now going in order. So it's Matt H against Set Rock 420. I wonder what he's going to rock 420 of.
That's 210 if you're a straight edge. I don't know. Oh my god.
Yoshi. Yoshi's the man who looks behind. Never look back, Yoshi. Never look back. Setrock certainly has been responsive in the past, but at the same time, we do need to make sure that he's going to be joining us and move on if he does not. Oh, there he is! Super cool! Awesome. Yeah, go ahead and jump in the room. Kept it warm for you. Yeah. Mm. Mm-hmm. Who else do you like to play? I think I've only seen you play Yoshi. Wasn't that one really fun day we played each other's mains? That was fun.
Sometimes I play Charizard. Sometimes I play Bowser.
Thank you for pronouncing the I in Charizard, by the way. Yeah, I never do, but yeah, it's there. It's like, you know, you can tell when people pay attention to the media they consume, and people call it like the Family Guy, which is actually the title. It hits the ear awfully, but you know, yeah, that's what it's called. So it's my bad. Cool. Here we go. Cool. On my screen. Oh, there you are, Set Rock. Cool. Super cool. Oh, I like your I like your me. Here we go. And now, Stead, we hear you in chat there, in the bracket. As I'm seeing it, you've been moved up. Let us know if that hasn't been updated for you. Yes. Only had one round so far where we actually had both players win one, and then we had to go to 2 out of 3. Well, it was always 2 out of 3, but the only time we played 3 rounds.
Set Rock, you're gonna kick my ass. I am not in.
That's what I like about you, Matt. I'm
not
confident.
I'm not in fighting spirit today.
Oh, good. Someone's playing Link. Excellent. Ho ho. Oh, nice dodge. Well done, Matt. Plus ultra. Nice.
Oh ho ho. Yeah. Oh ho ho.
Nice. Oh, jumping and grabbing, that's ballsy. That's hard. That's a very tricky thing to time, because that thing's just the grabs are just precise. Normally, you're so close, it doesn't make a difference, but with the Link...
Shit, I was hoping to get out of that.
Yeah. Ooh, nice. Oh, is that it? That's it.
No, it's not it. No, settle down, it. Steven, settle down.
I like it when Link smacks people around. Ooh, that's cool. What can I say? Nice. Excellent. He is
God
tough.
Damn it. I never land that. Why am I ever doing it? Oh, come on. I was trying to dodge that.
You made it to 154 damage. That's
I
really
did.
Cool.
Yoshi survives somewhat. Yoshi's hard. She's hard to kill.
Whoa, that's...
What are you doing there, Sarok? I'm not going to poke you off the edge, because...
I think he was waiting to either some kind of lag issue, or he was waiting to counter you as you clearly went for him. Interesting strategy.
Oh shit, didn't mean to do that. No. Oh my god.
Nice.
This is not going well for me.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I thought for sure he was gonna strike when he recovered. Oh heck yeah! That's awesome. That was satisfying. Okay. I think right now it's anyone's game. Matt,
no,
I love
it's totally not anyone's game. What are you talking about?
I was like, Matt, I love you, but I didn't think you'd get this far, so I think it might. There you go.
Oh, I totally landed that way too late.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I got hurt.
Yeah, Setrock's holding it down, but I mean, so are you, you know? I think right now he's playing more aggressive than you are. Link's just not that fast. Like, you really do. Your character has an advantage over him, definitely. Link's my main, so I would know. Like, when I see guys like Yoshi, I was like, ah, oh, damn it. But, no, you're good. You're good. You're good. Oh, I thought you were at 144, not 114.
No.
Cool, cool, cool. Whatever you did last time, I recommend it. Yeah, there you go. Oh, that was good though. That was close. You made it halfway through the time. That was excellent. You're being too hard on yourself. Link's totally tough to play. I'm sorry, Yoshi's totally tough to play.
Two or three, right?
Pretty easy. Yes, indeed. That was dope. Yes, indeed. As D-Power has been announcing, Yellowrello and Kayaka are next. Kayaka is present. Yellowrello doesn't even say yes. He just says LOL. Yeah, Rello's been here. Yellow's always around during the tournaments. It is nice. Yeah. Yes, indeed.
Time cool. For me.
You guys will be better after this. Nice. Oh, you guys will be. That D-Power was being snide.
Bowser.
You guys
playing
were better. Oh,
Bowser.
Bowser's cool.
I don't have to worry about that Link air spam shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know what you're doing. I don't know.
He strikes so fast. I was never super into Bowser. Yeah. Like, he doesn't move or jump that fast, but he strikes quick. Not like DK. DK is the only, like, big, heavy character I've really gotten into.
I'm sucking. That's what's going on here. I am out of you fuckers.
I thought that was you.
You got me like once. Twice.
Your arm is in frame, by the way, Robbie. No sooner do I say it.
Shit. I knew it was gonna happen. I knew it was gonna happen. I was like, this is bound to happen. I knew it was gonna
happen.
That's
what happens when we upgrade our equipment. We get D-Power creeping into the frame. We're not creeping into the frame, but joining us. All sly and stuff. Super cool. Swooped. He swooped us is what he did. I guess they're busy. Ooh.
I hate Bowser so much. His follow-ups just do so much damage. Oh my god.
I was going to say, I'm seeing the same thing pretty much every time I look up, but it is effective.
God. Good. Well played. That was not my A game.
Yeah. No, that's right. Cool. No, Bowser's another player that doesn't get a lot of play, so like I'm not even sure how to counter him. How I would carry him. I don't think that's what he meant by you suck. Yeah. Commentator bias. Ha! Thank you for playing, gentlemen. Thank you, Matt Hall. And thank you, Setrock. Setrock advances. We'll fight AJ Barra. And up next, it is Kayaka and Yellowrello. The yellowest Rello and the kaiest Ika. Kayaka, do you ever say Kika Kika like Pikachu? No, that was much funnier in my head. Redacted. Go ahead and forget I ever said that. All of my producers are applauding me. As well they should. Oh, can you smell what the rock is cooking? Can you smell it three times? This Yoshi Johns. Yeah. Cool. So, Kayaka and Yellow. Oh, and Kayaka approaches. And Rel approaches. Nice. Nice and quick. Oh, I gotta be rando. I don't have to be. But I wanna be. Yeah. Cool. Let's boogie. Do, do, do. Do, do, do. I should leave just for that? Yeah, no, you could win money. Normally I'd be like, you know what, I'm terrible. You should just go. But you might win some cash today. I think that's worth sticking around for. Yeah, and keeping the listings intact and stuff like that. Yeah. Yeah. But no, really, though, no one would blame you if you did leave. No one would blame you. Alrighty, ready. My duck and I need to run off the edge. Alrighty, make ready, everybody. I will apologize if I pop one of you. Sorry about that, Kaika. In 3, 2, 1, go! Good block. Good block by Kaika. And sorry if I was pushing off the edge there again. I do apologize. Oh, charging up with almost no distance. That's ballsy, but it can be effective. We saw Mewtwo doing that. Sven is Mewtwo, and uh-oh. Oh, there we go. Little bit of lag. Nothing's wrong. Kaika's now doing it with Samus. We're charging the attacks with almost no time left for just a little bit of charge. That's cool. Oh, I love the long-range grabs. I love the hookshot, and I love the grapple that Samus has. Too cool. Oh. Egg in the face. Egg in the face. Yellarello. That's right. Yellarello is the other one playing. Thank you, Matt. Yellarello is the other one playing Yoshi last time. I remember that. I remember seeing a black Yoshi around thinking Matt wasn't playing. That's cool. Nice and evenly matched. Both these. And I know I've been saying that a lot, but I mean, like, it doesn't normally turn out that way. So it's definitely worth it for me to point that out as a commentator. That everything's been really even keel. It's very cool. You know? Especially now that we're getting in the more advanced rankings, you know? Someone like Kaika and Yellarello, that's always going to be a good matchup. And I don't remember anybody playing Samus either this or last tournament. I just realized that. That's dope. Super cool. I think what we're seeing here is that both these players are so experienced that they're both being really reactionary. No one's being exploratory like they were in the first couple rounds this tournament. But nonetheless, nothing super aggressive right now. Both are definitely at it. You know, with 90 and 105 damage, both are definitely at it. But at the same time, no one's going nuts. I think both are just waiting to catch each other in a combo. And then steadily, one of them's going to get knocked out. And right now, Kaika's been keeping up the pressure. And right now, no, that's not true. Both of them being as defensive as they need to be.
Never mind.
Game! Yoshi knocks out Samus in quick order. That was good. That was nice, you know, like professional. Nice, steady push on both fronts. And absolutely knocked him, but yeah, nope. Start a coup in the Discord. Yeah, good game, everybody. That was awesome.
Super cool.
I could change the rules, but I won't. Oh, cool, everyone's keeping the same character. Nice. Nice.
Random.
Okay, keep that bracket up. And not quite. Up. Staggering drunkenly is something that all these characters have the potential to do. Cool. And here we go. That should have worked before. Interesting. Oh well, we go on. And oh good. For a second I thought this would be legit. Okay. I go over the edge. Once. And twice. Easy Kaika. Easy. Oh there we go. For a second. Sorry, with a little bit of lag we're seeing here, I thought you were going for it. So that's my bad. So, and 3, 2, 1, begin. Oh, good block, Kaika. Good tosses and good blocks. Those eggs are not that easy to aim, and Yellarella's been nailing all of them. Whoa. Yellarella nails Kaika as Zelda. Sorry. Once again, that's what my psychiatrist calls brain farting. So, excuse me. Oh, but that Zelda flying and teleporting. I want to call her as being out every time she goes off the edge, and she's just fine. Ugh. Nice brutal grab. Dope. Oh, nope, Zelda. Nice. She has a super long recovery period. I thought for sure that Yellowrello's would have connected, but no. Okay. Ooh. Zelda definitely being more defensive. That's working really well, especially with the abilities that we've been mentioning, with, you know, Zelda being able to basically fly and that long recovery time. But definitely, pressure's definitely on, thanks to Yellowrello. Definitely using those speedy little characters, you know. We saw the same thing with Nostad and Kirby, which is cool. Oh, and there she goes! Yoshi kicking Zelda right off the mat. Fly! Oh, well timed with that Phantom Soldier. Yoshi now up to 106 damage, but Yellowrello behind the wheel, I think this is still nice and close. Especially since Zelda's so low damage and Yoshi still has both lives. We're definitely not going to see a timeout, though. Definitely not. Ooh. That would have been decisive. That kick had landed. That kick of Yellow. Oh, ate and pooped. Ate and pooped. Oh, if it had been off the edge, that would have been cool. Fly out of that, Zelda. Oh, and there she goes. Oh, block! Yellowrello as Yoshi hanging off the edge. Jumps or strike, jumps and blocks or jumps and strikes. Just keeps Zelda from getting up to that edge. And that's it. That is awesome. Yellowrello, that was awesome. I had actually called that for Kayaka, to be honest. And that was excellent. Kayaka just being just really definitely playing super cool Zelda. But that was excellent. I think that's the best move I've seen in this tournament and the last. Like that was definitely done. Holding down when I shouldn't have. I see. Should have grabbed me at 86, says Yellowrello. Yoshi sucks, I forgot. You played him well. What can I say? Yeah, no, that was excellent. Good job, both of you. That was really close to call. And I did think it was going to be Kayaka. So Yellowrello, that was fantastic. So Yellow's super good. No, Rello's super good. Kayaka's super good. That was super satisfying for me. I hope you enjoyed it as well. So Kayaka like your Zelda. Yeah, that's awesome. Nick Nosedad. That's right. Cool. Nosedad wanted to be after this set. Nosedad is after this set. Yeah. Actually, no, that needs to be AJ Barra and Setrock before Nosedad. My bad. Nosedad, it looks like you and Yellowrello are going to be playing next. Yeah. So now, said Yellowrello, you are going to be after this upcoming one. Oh, I see what you're saying now. Yeah. So right now, even though you joined the room now, Stad, it's going to be AJ Barra and Setrock. Yeah. No, you're after this current set. So now, Stad, I see that you just joined, but right now, no, it is going to be AJ Barra and Setrock. So how do I... Whoa, sorry. I'm going to go ahead and choose not now Pharrell, because it's going to be AJ Barra, and Setrock. My bad. When Nosedad asked, can I be next, I thought he meant after this current round. But no, we're going in order, as you will see it on your screen on the challenge bracket. AJ Barra and Setrock to the main stage. We've got girls queued up for you. Wear something nice. That's all I'm going to say about that. AJ Barra, yes, sir. Okay, so right now, Nick, you're going to need... Oh, perfect. No sooner am I saying it does he back out. Thank you for your understanding. Nosedad. Setrock to the main stage. And Drew, that's right. I keep forgetting y'all's real names or whatever you're identifying as on the Nintendo friends list. So yeah. At me when it's my turn. Will do now, Stad. Setrock is here. Yep, we will definitely let you know when you are up. It's going to be after this match. I am Warren. I am Warren. AJ and Setrock. Yep, you got it. Alrighty, everybody. Sweet. Sour. No, that's good. I don't even know which character this is. Cool. Cool. Alrighty. I'm gonna go off the edge. To your sides, please. Oh, thank you for the good gamesmanship. Both players running into each other, but no one fighting. So I'm gonna go ahead and jump off the edge, and please begin in 3, 2, 1, go! Palatuna, I didn't even know who that is. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Mario, being his aggressive self, but Bayonetta is a scary person to sort of see wherever you find her. You know what I mean? Bayonetta is always cause for alarm. But then again, Mario is in the hands of a capable player as well. So, once again, and I know I sound like a broken record, but I really do mean it, which is, I think, one of the coolest things about this tournament, is that I couldn't call it. You know what I mean? AJ plays a good Bayonetta. I'm pretty sure I've seen AJ play Bayonetta in the last tournament as well. Setrock certainly knows what he's doing, though. Just not enough jump. Everything is perfectly timed. Everything is perfectly placed and right until Bayonetta made that last hit. And it really did come down to that last hit because if you're just a little bit closer, Setrock, you would have been able to make that grab. But Bayonetta's jump is just greater. You know what I mean? We're just longer. Ooh, that's nice and aggressive. Mario is that much faster, though. Yeah, this is the first match I've seen specifically Mario and Bayonetta up against each other. So there's a lot for me to talk about, but I have to say, like, you know, before seeing this matchup, just like, yeah, no, they're both really competitive and both their players know what they're doing. But this is the first I've seen, and Mario really is that much faster, you know? So I think Setrock might actually have an advantage here. Nice. So there goes AJ as Bayonetta, but everybody's still got a life left. And 40 is just not significant. So this still could go either way. Taking up the damage, though. Ooh, right at the edge. Ooh. I thought for sure AJ was going to come up and strike as they recovered off the edge. But not quite. And there goes... lag. There goes the signal. Huh. Sorry about that, folks. Our stream's not down. Our equipment is up and running, and we're just getting a little bit of lag. Oh, I see. We have a no contest. I do not know what happened there, folks. Interesting. You know what? That seems to be a technical issue, or a personal issue. We're just going to go ahead and start that one over. Yeah. Yeah, that one's not going to count for anybody. Oh, snaps, is her hop-up. Yes, indeed, Sir Hop-up. You have missed the registrations. There's always next time. Setrock forfeits. Setrock, are you trying to say that you were the one who called a quit because the lag out, or are you trying to say that you're no longer playing? Please clarify. Baby pulled the router. Your child pulled the router. Go to the losers, though. Oh, that sucks. We appreciate the gamesmanship that you know, it being your issue. I'll go ahead and add you now, Rello, and in case we have to go back, AJ's back. Yeah, you know what? Actually, they're the winner finals, not the losers finals. Yeah, Rello, go ahead and stay here, and then now, Stad, I'll go ahead and call you up now. Yeah, thank you for forfeiting, Setrock. Yeah, go to the losers. Yeah, thank you for the good gamesmanship. I was not prepared to hold that against you. I was prepared to just say, you know what, you had a technical issue, you resolved it and owned up to it, and you just started, we can start over. But things have already gotten moving, so I think we'll stick with what you just volunteered for, and we are going to take that as a forfeit, Set Rock. Thank you for your responsiveness, thank you for your gamesmanship. That's very cool of you. Interesting. But yeah, we move on. Nowstad is going to need to be messaged, as Nowstad has requested. So if one of our producers could do that, that would be awesome. Would let us say I'm going to need to sleep. Thanks for hosting. Kayaka, yeah, thank you. Thank you for being with us, Kayaka. Do get some sleep, my friend. All of us gamers know how that feels. Thank you for joining us. We're always happy to host every month. Unless there's a holiday, it's going to be the last Saturday of every month. So we're going to be on the November the 18th, because here we have Thanksgiving. November 18th is our next tournament, but we do this every month. We're happy to host. Thank you for coming. Now Stad is here. Already ready. Cool. With plenty of time to spare, go ahead and pick your fighter and we'll move on. I should have told Nick that you were doing another tourney. I did pretty well in the last one. Yeah. That's where I've seen your name before, Sir Hoppip. You know, I meet so many people. Nice. I meet so many people between Discord and Twitch that sometimes I lose track of who I meet just in the tournament. So that's, I do remember you, Sir Hoppip. You did do well. Yeah, Team Fortress 2 is our next tournament. I don't think we've released rules for that. But at the same time, it's definitely going to be Team Fortress 2, and it's going to be November Saturday the 18th. Yes, indeed. Again, it just conflicts with Thanksgiving, so we're doing it a week early. I haven't played Smash 4 in a while. Been super busy with other games. That's a good problem to have. Now Stead is ready. Oh, yes indeed. Sorry, I missed it. Cool. Let's get that going now. Okay. And Kaya, thank you for putting up with my terrible Pikachu joke from before. I appreciate your fortitude. You guys tolerate a sniper main? We can tolerate a sniper main, absolutely. We're tolerant of all kinds of players here at Mint Potion. Alrighty, as always, Nowstad, I'm jumping over your head. Well, not always Nowstad, but as always, I go, whoa, Yoshi's digging. He's dancing. Alrighty, sorry if I hit you, Nowstad. I go over in 3, 2, 1, begin. Go for it. Nowstad seems to be sticking to his try and true. Lots of little damage, very consistently, and seems to be going a lot faster, you know, more aggressively than early on. Which is fascinating to watch. It's not how the last tournament went at all. That's super cool. Yoshi getting a ton of play. Yoshi's difficult to play well. Very cool when they do. When he is played well. And Yellow Rella. Oh, yeah, I had to double check that. Michael, ladies and gentlemen.
Give you a hand with this.
Almost pooped him off the edge. Oh, sorry to interrupt you, but I get too excited. Everyone remembers that.
I thought Nostad's name said mustard for a second. I think it's the yellow.
Yeah.
So we got this. Yoshi's been putting in work, I've been seeing.
Yeah. Yoshi and Mario. Two characters I don't see much. And then there's Samus, Bowser, and Zelda that I've never... Maybe like Pikachu.
Oh.
Oh nice. Man.
I thought that would have been... Oh, if that kick after the headbutt had connected, that would have been decisive. I think that might have been... That might have been a ring out.
Yeah, both players being careful, getting their spacing together.
Oh, dead even. I thought that was ring out, actually. Yeah. I think I'm just not as familiar with Yoshi as before, because I was like, oh, nope, that would have won.
Yeah, Yoshi can be dangerous.
Yeah, definitely. And getting knocked into the ground is a unique frustration to feel.
Oh, man. Pressure's on.
Yeah, yeah. Huh. The player's a little standoffish now.
Oh,
no. Kirby's tough.
He's going for that kill. Oh. He wanted that.
Nice. Yoshi.
Good work.
Super cool. Yeah. Oh, super cool, Rello. Not that I'm surprised. Yeah, you do really well with Yoshi, Rello. Nowzeta's doing really well with Kirby, too.
Mm-hmm.
That's very cool. You both have very different approaches. So far, both this tournament and last, Yellow Rello's a lot more aggressive. So, frankly, I really thought that it was going to be Yellow Rello a lot sooner. But after a while, mm-hmm. I thought, Nowzeta's just on top of it. Nowzeta's just, solid as a rock as far as doing damage over time from beginning of the match to the end. I was just like, I have no idea which way that's going to go. And once again, I know I sound like a darn broken record, but like it's just way cool to see for anybody, especially for me as a commentator, because mm-hmm. Sometimes it gets really skewed and you're just like, okay, what five ways do I have of saying that guy's going to win clearly? And that's not happening in this game, and it's super dope. Cool. So, all right, Rob is going to go straight off.
We got Wario. Ouch. Interesting.
Nice. I've never seen Wario in Smash Wii U. All right, everybody. In 3, 2, 1, begin. Super dope. Opening up with driving a chopper across somebody seems pretty strong, but Nowzeta took that very well. Yeah.
It's a power move.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah, so I think Wario's a better character to kind of counteract Kirby's shortness. And all the dodging. Roy has more like close range attacks and stuff like that. His bike can hit a larger hitbox.
Got it. Cool. Oh, he was asking for it with that open mouth.
Oh, there it is.
Thank you for the compliment, Setrock. I really appreciate that. He says thank you for the stream energy.
Thanks,
yeah, absolutely. No, thank you for being here.
Yeah.
We wouldn't be a studio if we didn't have our people, if we didn't have our community, We're certainly capable of running stuff, and then what would be the point if we didn't have you guys, I mean, I've certainly seen bad gamers play good games, so I get my energy from you all. Absolutely.
We have our own personal Wario back here.
One of our producers is doing impressions. I thought we had a speaker turn on spontaneously all of a sudden. To be honest, it scared the bejesus out of me. That was really well played, Nosed, though. That was awesome. I was just like, I think this is okay, but now. And then now, though, no, that was excellent. Yeah, good game, everybody. GGs. Yeah. GGs. Thank you for a good show, Yellarello as Wario. I had no idea if that character is easy or difficult to play, but you certainly played. Certainly played super well.
Definitely.
Yeah. So, yeah. That was awesome. So, yeah. No, Yellarello. Yeah, that was, I'm right, right?
Yeah, the finals and the bronze. Or the bronze, right. Bronze and the finals.
Yeah, yeah. So, this is, so we have, this is the last, of the semifinals, for Eddie's Chomp 8. Yeah, that was impressive. Yeah, that's a good point. The winner finals and the bronze match, which is what we're going to now, are the, so the loser of 13 and 14, so Setrock and Nosed are going to fight, and that's going to be the bronze match. The bronze match, as well as the finals, are going to be best out of 5. So that's exactly right. Same deal, 2 stock and 6 minutes, unless we have a tie, in which case it's going to be 1 stock and 3 minutes.
A tiebreaker.
Super cool. Yeah, and now that we're getting into it, winner of winners for first, second, and third. Post your position. Your winning places. You know whether you came first, second, third. On challenge and message us. That's how we are going to pay you. We will handle getting the money to the charity whose value we're matching for the $250. But how we are going to be paying you personally is you post your positions, and then we will, as I said, mail you bags of quarters. No, we're not. we're going to be PayPaling you, and we never got back to Nosed about Bitcoin. That's a good question.
Bitcoin, interesting.
Yeah,
are you working on the dark web? You doing some black market movements?
That's a good way to accumulate your dark currency. Is Smash Brothers?
I'm sure there's some type of underground Bitcoin smash break.
Druidog, hello! Setrock, yes indeed. Oops.
Oh.
He left.
Okay.
I hope I didn't hit B. No, I hit A. Okay. I apologize if that was my fault, Setrock. I'm pretty sure I hit A.
No,
but dude, yeah, dude, come back, Setrock. That is you. Yeah, Setrock and Nosed. You are up. Whisper D powers, that'll work. Yeah, if you message us in some way, shape, or form. Challenge was how I was told to ask you to post your positions. But if you get in contact with us, we'll make it work. PayPal too? Yeah. We will, yeah, you post it on our, there he is, Setrock. And then we will get in contact with you. Sir Hoppet, Mains Roy, and Corn on the Cob.
On the Cob.
That's an interesting gamer snack, is Corn on the Cob.
Corn on the Cob.
That's very funny. Cool.
Corn on the Cob. Corn on the Cob.
Yeah. That makes you play games with one hand for a long time, that Corn on the Cob. Cool.
Should be a new challenge.
Yes, indeed.
Thank you.
Oh, boy. Smashville. Smashville Slugger.
Wario.
And oh,
Wario's your worst character. Yeah, Wario's I never was good with Wario myself either.
Yeah, I've never played him, but just seeing the way he handles, he's just, yeah, I would not get good with that.
He's not better than in Brawl, for sure.
Yeah.
Huh.
I choose to believe that the world's most interesting man is that is the guy who's underneath Captain Falcon's mask.
It is a mystery.
Yeah.
So people were actually modding like a maskless Captain Falcon.
That's funny. Once again, I go over the edge. Actually, that's a really cool idea. I heard mod. I was just like, ooh, I love mods. All right. In 3. Ooh, sorry about that, Nosed. I apologize. 3, 2, 1, begin. Ooh, cloud right out. Oh, but Marth just intercepts him. Nosed, not Green Kirby for once. Instead is big old Cloud being nice and aggressive.
Almost right.
Yeah. Setrock just caught him perfectly. This is cool. This is a very, vaguely Soul Calibur-esque type of matchup where everybody's got a weapon and no one's really short range because everyone's got a sword as long as they are.
exactly.
Yeah. Ooh, nice. Nice. Ooh,
getting
more cautious.
And
yeah.
Those counters, though.
Yeah. I think both players are anticipating each other. I think that we're well into the tournament enough that both Everybody is just being nice and aggressive.
Yep.
Overall, but I have to say, they've started anticipating each other, which is interesting. You know, caution is to the wind, but nonetheless, everybody like in the game with Nosedad and Yellow Rello, where both were just trying to catch each other in a combo. You know, no one was holding back, but things were going kind of slow. You know, and right. both are just trying to catch each other in those dope chains of hurt. Yeah. But Nosedad does. Nosedad's holding it down, though.
He's got to watch the Marth's tip. Marth's
tip.
That's the danger spot.
Where it begins is the tip.
Oh.
Yep, there we go.
Ooh, holding on to that limit.
Yeah.
Now he has no choice.
He's over the edge already. I don't know.
He's got that.
He's got it.
Oh,
he's
got that rage going right now.
That's
he's
good edge technique. Yeah. I didn't realize that the Cloud could do that. He could attack through a ledge. That's awesome. Is it still charged? Whatever that Cloud's ability is, because it looks like he lost it. Whatever it was. There he is. Oh, perfect. Oh. Perfect block. Perfect timing.
There it is.
There it is.
That took a while.
Yeah. Yeah, he was set to just recover and attack right all over again, but Cetrock just not having it. Just good old bubble shield. Oh,
yeah, there. All right. That's nice. Cetrock's had enough of this.
Yeah. That was super cinematic and super effective. I didn't realize how fast Marth's grab is. That was like you recovered immediately. That's why I don't grab that much when I play Link. I am pigeonholing myself to my main. I know, but but I mean, like that grab has such a long. You know, animation that it's just, you know, like I just get hit every time I do it. That's dope.
Yeah, it's a risky grab for sure.
Definitely.
Oh, he's Marth's a little less up. There it is. See?
Oh.
Marth still got it. Got that good.
He's going to have it charged by the time he lands, too. There's Marth. Ooh. Marth. Oh, definitely turned it around, but right. Oh.
Yeah, he could have countered there. That would have been a good time because Cloud was wide open with that up smash.
That's going to do it. I think that's there it. Is. Excellent. That's awesome. Yellow Rello, I thought in that very first burst of aggression that Cetrock as Marth had it, and I apologize for calling you Yellow Rello. I meant to call you Nosedad there. Nosedad with Cloud absolutely had it. That was excellent. But yeah, no, that was great. Good game.
Very, very clean Marth.
Yeah. No, that was good.
You don't see a lot of Marth in... competitive tournaments too much either.
Yeah, I think, and this is entirely my inference just from my own experience, but I mean, like, he was so powerful in Melee and Brawl
that
I feel like they're
melee,
just like,
sure.
Yeah, let's just turn them down.
He's still pretty decent in this game. You just don't see him too much.
So
since he's so close range.
Right.
Where's the Lucario?
Oh, hey, Drew.
Have you seen any Lucario?
Haven't met you before. Cool. Alrighty, so we're coming up on our second game, and I'm going to go ahead and hop myself off the edge. Try not to hit anybody. There's one. And sorry for the people I've been nudging as I've been doing that. I never mean to. Speaking of which, and 3, 2, 1, fight! Ooh, once again, charging up with almost no time left. That's always ballsy. You know, we've been seeing that a lot. I think just because we have good advanced players, just like, no, I can charge this a third.
Yeah,
a
just, second, getting, just getting that extra credit, we call it.
I like that. Extra credit. Yeah. Dope.
Clouds are getting really dangerous with the up airs.
Oh, yeah. Nice. Oh!
Ran right into that
Very quick.
Got two antsy there.
Very quick.
So far, it looks like it might be Nalsad's game. He's got a huge lead.
Yes.
Cyrock's going to have to do a lot of catching up.
Yeah. I think Cetrock could push through.
He can,
Marth is a great character for it. He's playing him really well.
He's got the spacing down.
Yeah. Now Seth's not going to let that happen exactly, though. Ooh, there you go.
Yep, that's it. Yep. Cloud's recovery is not good, and we are back to a relatively even match just like
definitely.
That.
One stock to one stock. 35 damage is not significant. Oh, that's ticking up now, though.
Yep, there you go.
There it is.
He's racking up. Balancing the playing field a little bit.
Yeah. No, this is good. This is less defensive on both people's parts. Nice. Ooh. There's a good quick grab.
I thought for sure Marth was going to... That's it.
I thought for sure. Nice Nosedad. Nice.
Good work.
That was a good... Yeah, that was like the round with... with Yellowroa now said, where it was nice and nice and solid and consistent, and, you know, very professional, very just business-like, just show up and really hit it. Both players, though, did get more aggressive, which is always fun to watch. But yeah, really well played, Set Rock. That was super cool. But yeah, congratulations. Congratulations, Nosedad. You have won. No, you've not won. We have one more.
Yeah, we
I'm
have
so
one
sorry.
More.
Yeah, no.
Won the match.
Man, I've been announcing it. Yeah, one more because we are in the bronze match, which is 3 out of 5. So I've been announcing it all day, and I almost made that mistake myself. Forgive me. So yeah, we have one more unless Set Rock pulls it out, in which case we keep going. Speaking of keeping going, there we go. Boss Galaga's
Lucario.
Nice.
G-Dig really wants Lucario.
That'd be cool. Lucario. Nice. Oh, Martha's very common. Super cool. One more. You got this. Yes, indeed. 2, 1. I can't handle it. I'm going over the edge. Oh, easy. Easy, everybody. Easy.
You're too antsy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I made the same mistake. So,
yeah. It's fine. Yeah, no. That's
just get ready.
No worries. Yeah, no, that happens. No, I really appreciate the energy. I really appreciate the fact that we're in our first best of five.
So much enthusiasm.
And yeah, no, definitely. Cool. So, no worries. We're just gonna go ahead and start that one right over.
So have we seen a Lucario this match at all? Or this tournament?
No. I mean, like, I've been pulling him as the random and then jumping off the edge. But I mean, that's bad. Yeah. But no Lucario. Interestingly enough, yeah, that's one that I would have expected to see as well.
Any reason you want Lucario, Druidig? Druidig.
Super cool.
So, yes, indeed. Cool. I go off the edge. And I do it again. Sorry for nudging you now, Stat. And 3, 2, 1, begin. Oop, charging right, again. He's going to get full charge by the time he gets there.
Charging up. Lemon in the flood.
Yeah.
Preparing for the future.
Yes, indeed. Nice. Now, Stat.
And you got the up tilt combo here.
Yeah, Mario's no joke. Mario's just... You'd think... I'm really glad Nintendo pulled back from letting Mario just be, like, the king of this game. Because, I mean, like, Mario does not have to be the boss of every... The big badass of every game, you know? And they never really did that, even going back to the beginning. But he's gotten steadily more interesting. Well, oh. Yeah. No, you just timed it a little wrong. Yep.
Yeah, I forgot about that jump.
Yeah. Set Rock, that's...
Gotta watch your jumps, because once you run out of jumps, you're...
Yeah. And Mario's jumps aren't that good. You know, like, that's clearly where he bounced. Like,
ironically enough.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. Totally missed that. Thank you, Mike. Nice.
Apparently, Set Rock has a good Lucario, so he's trying to get Set Rock to use him.
Dope.
Maybe we'll see that later on, potentially. Mm-hmm. Oh, there it is.
Ooh, nice. He's still in it, though. And he's got plenty of room to spare. Mario's just coming down right in the middle. And I think he's about to.
Very high damage, though. He's got to be careful.
Yeah.
Oh, he got the spike. That's definitely going to come in handy.
Mm-hmm.
Using those invincibility frames, charge up the limit.
Oh, yeah. Is that what it's called? The invincibility frame?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Oh, there it is. It's going to be the game.
Yep. Cloud, man. I think Cloud's just a great counter to Mario, because that was really well played of both Set Rock and Nosedad. And I mean, like, Mario's a tricky character to play, and I think Cloud's the perfect counter, because he's got more power and longer range with that sword and a better, like, jump and stuff like that. So my hat's off to you, Set Rock, because that was sure. really well played. And ballsy, I got to say, for choosing Mario. And Nosedad, really well done, my friend. So that is it. Nosedad advances and is going to be our third place as the winner of the bronze match. Yellowrello, nice and responsive right on top of it. Thank you so much, Set Rock. It was super. Thank you for all the kind words. Thank you for playing. You held it down really, really well throughout the tournament. That's super dope. So yeah, we are on our final match of AJ Barra and Yellowrello.
Mm-hmm.
Third best master, as we used to call this tournament. I completely forgot about that. He's doing the subtle thing. We had this, we called this tournament originally was third best master.
Third best master.
Yeah. So now Stat is our third best master. That's awesome. And Setrock, thank you for putting up with me butchering your name. Citroke.
your boy didn't win.
Oh, I'm sorry. Everybody's waiting. Sorry, a little bit of housekeeping. I had to do off-frame there. I missed that. I apologize. So, here we go. Final match. Best of five.
We have a ghost back here.
We have a couple of ghosts back here doing very funny things that managed to distract me. I'm trying to keep my professionalism, believe it or not. So, yes. Our final best out of five. AJ Ibarra, Yellow Rello. I need but jump off the edge. One more time after this one. And in 3, 2, 1, begin.
All right, this is going to be a tough one.
Here we go. AJ as Bayonetta and Yellow Rello as Mario. I think these are the best characters I've seen of these two players. Super cool. Yeah, I have no idea who to call for this one. I was just talking about how Mario doesn't have the greatest jump and it's kind of hard to play. But right now, in the hands of Yellow Rello, that's going to be super cool. But then again, AJ's Bayonetta... he's got the best Bayonetta I've seen so far. I think one other person this tournament played it, and I believe it was Setrock. But last tournament, Bayonetta got a bunch of play. We had three or four people playing Bayonetta, and AJ's Bayonetta is dope. So this is gonna be
flood. Gotta watch that joint.
No, that thing really pushes you around. That's hard to counter because that's like one of the longer range attacks I think in the game. That isn't a projectile that'll go the map. So that's really on his dry. I was just like, and there it is. Oh no.
Tried.
Yeah. So that was well played. Over the edge, AJ did go, but I mean, like, that was due to no fault of his own. I'm assuming their own.
If Bayonetta could have went for the spike there, not to, but it might not.
He's alive.
Yep.
He's alive.
Still working.
Yeah.
Yeah, both of these characters are very, very dangerous with good players.
Oh yeah. Nice. Good edge technique. I didn't realize that Mario's up B could move you that much when you land on the ground. Like, cause he just slid right over as soon as he got up in the edge. That was dope. Is he going to do it again? He's going to try to.
Yep, there it is. Got back
167
here.
Damage. I'm surprised he lasted that long against Bayonetta. AJ's Bayonetta, yeah.
Still anybody's game?
Oh, yeah. A little bit of defense, but not a lot. Which is what you want to see late in the tournament, which is nice, nice aggressive play.
Oh.
Yep. Nope.
Almost not caught even. Him. Nothing too far, though.
Yeah. With these two, we're going to see a lot of that. A lot of almosts. Excellent. Nice.
All right. It's going to go for the ladder. Oh, yeah, she got the bat, the inner bat.
Dodge.
Wow. Playing it careful.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Yep, there it is.
There it is.
First game.
There it is. Yellow Rello as Mario. Gets the first game. Nice.
Yeah, close match.
Yeah. Doot, 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 doot.
Yes, this is probably anyone's set here.
Yeah. This is going to be awesome.
Seem pretty even.
Right. That is how Yellow Rello did so well last tournament, which is just... which is just came up from behind. Like it was really, or not from behind, but I mean, like, really, like, progressively got even better. And Yellow Rello was one of the first players to go back and forth. I look like Harry Potter.
Robin Potter. Harry Rob.
I like that. Robin Thicke and Robin Potter. I like it. And I apparated too.
Let me disapparate.
Alrighty, going off the edge a second time, and in 3, 2, 1, begin. Oh, dodge it completely with that huge range. Managed to dodge it all. AJ does. Okay. Actually overshoots it with that attack.
It seems like they're both...
Yes, it is. Sorry?
They're both kind of not sure what the other player's going to do here.
Yeah, they're a little bit more cautious, but I feel like that's not going to be too long-lived. Both players still playing really confidently, though. You know, that's something I didn't notice in this tournament at all. That I know, like, last tournament isn't really a fair comparison to this one because we had so many more participants. We had, God, I don't know, 30-something people last time?
Oh, wow.
We had 17 this time. So, like, in the beginning of last tournament, we had a lot of people that were really, you know, you could tell weren't that confident. Oh, that's it for Mario!
It is.
I kept thinking to myself, they're going to grab and they're going to up B and then, oh, not quite. AJ is just,
here.
I mean, Bayonetta is just too lithe. It just moves around too much. Sorry to interrupt you. What were you saying?
No, no, no.
Yeah.
That's it.
Cool. But yeah, but this tournament, and I think it's just because it's smaller and we have more experienced people, no lack of confidence. You know?
Yep.
A little bit of anticipation going on.
Yeah,
bit of
they're definitely trying to
on.
Read each other for
sure.
Yeah.
Oh! Oh, yeah, yeah. Nice. Mario didn't like being wrung out like that. Mario went right for it.
Yep. So now it's back to even.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of trade-off.
Right. Nice.
Yeah, I'm noticing it's very hard for these two characters to get off combos that, like, work.
Right.
Usually, because Bayonetta is able to kind of get out of Mario's typical combos, and Mario's able to get out of Bayonetta's typical combos.
So yeah,
yeah. I'm sure it's very frustrating.
Yeah. Oofed.
Oh. Yeah. AJ going for those double hits, but it's just not working out.
Right, right.
Why is it too high damage?
Yeah, no, Yellow Roll is not going to let that happen.
Aerial jab. Both I'm still playing it smart.
Oh, yeah.
That might do it.
Yep. Not quite. Oh, no. No.
That's it. Let's stop from the... Fireball.
Excellent.
Crazy.
There goes Yellow-rello. Now, this being the final round, we have at least one more unless AJ can pull it out. Then we just keep on going. But yes, that was two. We need at least one more to declare a winner. So, yes, we can change the rules, but I don't want to. These are too good.
Don't do that.
Yeah.
Keep it going.
Yes, indeed.
Yes, Yellow-rello's got the lead. So AJ's gotta try to do his best not to crack under the pressure of
I don't think he will.
Behind.
I don't think he will.
It's easier said than done.
Always.
$125 riding on the winner of this match. Alright, this could be it. This could be the last match.
Yeah.
Let's see how it turns out.
Yes, dude. Sorry about that, Alpha. Sorry for nudging you. I'll try. And 3, 2, 1, begin! Alright. AJ being nice and aggressive right at the outset, and then a Yellow-rello just with that really effective giant ranged hose, you know?
Yeah, he's been starting every match with that, and it's been working out.
I wonder how memorable Super Mario Sunshine is for most people, because I love 3D platformers, so I remember that game, but I can imagine so many like millennials just seeing that in this game going, what the hell is that thing?
No, that's
what
a classic.
What is that squirt gun? Is it? Oh, I'm sick. That's a relief. Good. Nice. Both players more aggressive already. Feeling that late tournament, that late tournament pressure.
Oh yeah, the jitters get to you. I felt them at the beginning of the tournament.
Super dope.
There it is. Oh, they got too greedy with the grabs.
Uh-huh.
Let AJ escape.
Dope.
Yeah. AJ not able to follow up with the combos there.
Right. Oh, that big fist.
Doing all the damage is too high.
What is that? Oh, man. You get so much control with Bayonetta.
Oh god, the lag. Not never good. Nope. There we go. we're back in business.
Yeah, sorry about that lag, everyone. Yeah. That's
Nintendo, please.
Yeah, that's
send an email to Nintendo America at Nintendo.com.
Tell Shiggy you want the game to run faster.
Yeah.
All right. right.
Hit Sakurai.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, this round's a lot really nice and nice and aggressive, but both players are just really good at playing defense just as well. Like, we're so even keel. Like, we are 5% difference in damage, and I don't think it's been greater than, like, 15 throughout the entire round so far.
Yep, and we're getting some frame drops there, so it's getting even trickier.
Right. That's it. That's only first
AJ
life.
AJ wants this W right now.
Oh, yes.
Grab. Oh, there it is.
Oh, there it is.
Yep. Back to even. Just like that. Yeah. AJ walking up slowly, all confident.
Yeah.
Yeah, both of them trading combos, interrupting the other person.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Nice.
Good thing it's going to work out there. Yeah, Rella's going to rack up some nice damage
here. Yeah, lots of short combos. Like, you mentioned that before. I was like, that's a great point. Not a bunch of huge chains here, you know? Like, that's definitely, like, the more advanced players...
Yeah, as you say that.
Yeah, as I say it. The more advanced players tend to favor the shorter combos. It's just got to be speed.
Uh-oh. Okay.
Not quite.
Almost went for the ladder
there.
Not
quite. Yeah, that camera confused me for a while. I was like, oh, Mario's dripping down my screen already. But no... Yellow Rello. Still in it. Oh, there we go.
The players pacing themselves right now. There.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, man. You just gotta be really careful with that flood on the edge.
Oh.
Especially since this is his last stock. Could be the last stock of the game.
I forgot she has guns. Yeah. I don't know. Mario, 133. Yellow Rello.
Tough.
Yeah.
All Yellow Rello needs is like one, good up smash. That could be it.
Yeah. But then we just keep going. It'd be even closer.
Yep.
Oh, I thought that was it.
Not able to seal the deal just yet.
Even Peppers with a fireball on the way down. Oh, man.
I'm so nervous.
Yeah.
Up. That's it.
There she goes. Nope. No.
It's close.
Oh, man. No, saves it at the edge. That's it. Okay, no, AJ wins his first.
Work.
AJ wins his first game this match.
Good
so
work.
We keep on going. We have 2-1.
Good work.
Yellow Rello has 2. AJ has 1.
Nice.
Nicely done. All right, let's keep going. It would lag there. Yeah, you're right, Yellow. Yeah.
Yeah. That's unfortunate. That's the problem with the online tournaments. It's unpredictable lag.
Absolutely. Pardon
Hopefully,
my French.
If we get it for the Switch, hopefully they can kind of remedy that situation.
Hopefully.
All right, here we go. This is getting juicy. Yo.
Come on, Pilot Wings.
Getting juicy.
No one wants Pilot Wings.
One people might not remember.
No. It used to be the crappy launchware game, and I didn't realize that because I loved it so much when I was a kid, and they're just like, nope. Going back to NES, they made Pilot Wings to give away with the system until they broke down and gave you Mario. But yeah.
Yep.
Alrighty.
Oh, man. Got the Switch.
Hoo-ah. Yeah.
Switching the Yoshi.
Yellow Rello. Back to Black
That's
Yoshi.
A problem.
Alrighty.
As we've seen.
And 3, 2, 1, fight. Ooh, egg to the face. You got egg on your face. Ha, Bayonetta. Alrighty.
We're starting with a lot of spacing, and then now they're getting right into it.
Oh, yeah.
Nitty-gritty.
Yellow Rello, Yoshi is who Yellow Rello is playing throughout last tournament. Excuse me.
words.
Yeah, and I figure, it doesn't surprise me that after almost winning the tournament last game, come back with Yoshi.
And Yellow Rello going for the spike early, but it didn't work out.
Pilot Wings. No, I'm not hating on it. No, I love it. No, I was just, I heard that and it stuck with me that Pilot Wings is a launch title.
Yeah.
Because I was just, what are you talking about? Pilot Wings is amazing. That it has a ridiculous plot twist. Thank you, Takes. Also, nice to meet you, Take-72. I've never seen you around. Whoa.
Man.
Whoa.
AJ.
Wow. AJ.
AJ's finished with these games.
AJ wants it. Man, I was nerding out over Pilot Wings and I almost missed that. My God.
He's
almost.
Leaving the heart of the cards right now.
Right? Man.
Oh, man. Okay, good.
Yeah, Yellow Rello didn't like that.
Yellow Rello's getting a little antsy. He's trying to get rid of AJ.
Oh, chewing on him.
Good measure.
Good measure. Oh, man, that was cool. Went right under the egg. Ooh. Almost. I think that's a great way to counter Bayonetta. It's just whatever small projectiles you have, they keep pushing Bayonetta
let's
back.
Keep her away.
Because she can jump so much and so far.
Got the witch time. Missed opportunity. Did not use that.
That was dope.
The fullest potential.
That must have does that have a cooldown time? It must.
Yeah, well, the higher the damage the opponent has when you use that move, the longer it lasts. Age had a decent amount of time.
Right.
But didn't use the right move there.
Gotcha.
There it is.
Oh, there goes Bayonetta.
Yellowrella wants this win.
Yellowrella wants it.
Once again,
so
could
does
be the
AJ.
Last
stop. Man. I think it could, even though we're at like 84 damage to like 20 now, I still think it's close as could be.
Yeah, it's pretty close. Yellowrella can still pull it out.
Definitely. Nice.
Oh, nice.
I was just like, unless he's about to fall off, but no, just egging and flying all the way around.
You do not want to be an arrow Bayonetta. That is never a good, never a good thing. Which unfortunately, a lot of Yoshi's combos are aerial based, so it's gotta
be
careful.
Most of them are, aren't they?
Yeah.
Dope.
Yep.
Oh,
man.
AJ
wants it. Oh, this is it.
Oh, yeah.
There it is. That's it. That's game.
That's game.
And we're
game
five.
2-2. Yeah.
Game
Sorry,
five.
When you said game, I thought you were turning. I was like, oh my god, no, there's more. Take 72 says, been aware of Mint Potion for a long while, mostly because of Jake. Yeah, most people are aware of us because of Jake. But I really like everyone involved. Barely get a chance to tune in. Well, thank you for joining us today, then, Take 72. Glad to have you. Now, Stad.
DM, D-Power, and Discord. Perfect. That should work just fine with us. Thank you, Nostead.
Moving on to game five.
Yeah.
Final match of the tournament.
This is going to be it. This is as close as it can be, unless there's a tiebreaker here.
That would be insane.
That would be
I think these players are moving too quick there's no really like passive
So
it'll probably.
I know it was fun last tournament when because we were playing Rocket League, we would time out. And then everyone was just trying to keep the ball off the ground because we were playing hoops to keep the game. Maybe Yellowrello and AJ are like next to each other like you and I are right now. And they're just like, no, let's keep it going. Let's make it really close.
It's a conspiracy.
Yeah. Alrighty. I go off the edge and I'm going to try not to nudge anyone as I do it again. And 3, 2, 1, begin. Alrighty, a classic matchup. Now going to be a Mint Potion Tournament classic of Yoshi and Bayonetta being played by Yellowrello and AJ. Oh.
Yellowrello so going for good. The early kill.
Oh, yeah.
Work out, though.
Yeah.
Ooh. This is tense.
Yeah.
Oh. I almost had a nice Bayonetta combo there.
Yeah.
Wasn't able to fall through, though.
Not quite. As even could be. Yeah, Bayonetta's never done when she's that close to the edge. Yeah.
Been a lot of that.
Oh, man. She just witch timed a projectile. Slowed it down. That's dope. Oh. You gotta be careful. I'll never forget seeing a Yoshi facing you with his butt towards the edge. That means one thing. Wouldn't it be funny if that's what won the tournament?
You never know.
Yeah.
Yeah, so now we're getting a little more passive here, trying to play it careful, play it safe.
Safer
than the previous rounds, for sure.
Right. Still nice and fast, though.
Yeah. Ooh.
Nice.
It's a good hit. Good aim.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, those eggs. Oh, those eggs.
Oh, yeah. That's a great counter for Bayonetta. Just push her away so that even her jump can't save her. Yep. Oh, nope, not even. Oh.
Yeah, watch. Gotta time that air dodge.
Yeah,
a little too early. Got a little antsy with that up smash. Yep, there it is. It's gonna be stock.
That's
Could
it.
This be the last
one
stock?
More. Oh man. I thought for sure she's gonna run up and just kick Bayonetta off the edge. Just like, alright, fine, now you have one stock. Oh.
Yep, racking up.
Oh man,
that
for
extra
a second.
Credit.
I couldn't tell who's attacking who that time. Look at that.
That's going to be it. All right, here we go.
All righty, here we go. Last life. Last life, last round.
I'll stock to rule them all.
Don't bring a gun to an egg fight. That's all I'm going to say.
Bayonetta's fought demons and angels and gods, but cannot get her way around an egg.
Yeah, that cute little dinosaur, though. Well, I don't know. We'll see.
Oh boy.
Yeah, very cautious. Now, yeah, this both anticipating each other now. You got a Mexican standoff. Oh, there we go.
Using those eggs.
Oh yeah.
Creating some distance, racking up some damage.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Which is good and bad, because Yoshi's so short range with everything else.
Yeah, so it's gonna be hard. It's gonna be hard for AJ to approach.
Right.
Unless utilizes the guns, but they're not as effective because they don't have the same knockback the Yoshi's eggs do.
Oh. Okay, it's getting decisive. We're in the 80s and 90s. Oh, so close. That recovery smash is pretty strong at Bayonetta, so I was like, wow, that might... But no. Yoshi's going to be headbutting and kicking soon.
There it is.
That is the game. Congratulations, Yellow Rello. As his signature now classic
Min Potion Tournament Classic, Black Yoshi against the our other new Min Potion Classic, AJ Ibarra as Bayonetta, Yellow Rello. Thank you both so much for playing, but Yellow Rello has won our second ever Super Smash Brothers tournament. 3 out of 5 goes to Yellow Rello.
That's clean. Those are good matches.
Absolutely. No, that was wonderful. Thank you both. That was so exciting, AJ, watching you get the last couple at the last second. They're getting nice and hungry for it. Yeah, great game, everybody.
Super clutch.
Yeah, absolutely. That was wonderful. Thank you all so much for our first big stream with our new equipment.
Yeah, thanks for having me, man.
Absolutely.
Up here.
No, thank you for playing. Yeah, thank you for sure. Come jumping back in and casting with me. I always appreciate that. For double duty, player and competitor and caster. That's cool as hell. D-Power, send it in on Discord, asked Yellow Rello. That should work just fine. AJ whispered it. Yellow Rello, Discord should do fine. I believe that's what Nowstead does. We're always happy to host. Thank you for being here.
Thanks, AJ.
We wouldn't have anything to host if it wouldn't be for you all. So thank you. That's wonderful. Yeah, and I think we'll hear from our producer which charity is that we're going to be matching the funds for. So that $250 pot, we always match for charity. And we're talking about hurricane relief for Puerto Rico and local music education.
That's good stuff.
Yeah, Puerto Rico it is. We're gonna be concerned and care about local music education here where we're based in Southern California forever. But right now the people of Puerto Rico need our help. So $250 is going to hurricane relief for our fellow Americans down in Puerto Rico. And enjoy your winnings. Absolutely. Will there be another Smash Trinity? Most definitely at some point in the future. Yes, that's a great question, Take72. We don't like to do the same game, 2 or 3 months in a row. Mm. Our next tournament is going to be Team Fortress 2. Normally it's the last Saturday of every month. November, that is Thanksgiving. So on November 18th. So that's going to be the third Saturday, I believe, is going to be our next tournament, and it's Team Fortress 2.
Awesome. Yeah, I got to come back and prove myself, redeem my skills in the next Smash tourney.
Absolutely.
Or maybe Rocket League.
Yeah. And who knows? Maybe by then they'll have announced Super Smash Brothers for Switch.
Hope
God
so.
Knows
got
that's
the
wishful
controller
thinking
working
on my part. Yeah. Thank you for the kind words, AJ. We're always happy to donate. Yeah, absolutely. Wonderful. Yeah. If you have any, I couldn't imagine this going any better. But if anybody has any suggestions, we have a suggestion box thread on our Discord, or you could always message us on Twitch. Thank you all for everything. Yellow Rello, it was your suggestion to use Challenge last tournament, so thank you for that. That's gone really smoothly for this and our other tournament we used it for, which is Rocket League, and probably going to be sticking to it. Speaking of which, we have not finalized the rules yet for our Team Fortress 2 tournament, so we're going to be running it through Challenge, but at the same time, we've not released rules for it quite yet. Post suggestions on Discord. Help us figure out those rules. And we've been joking about bags of coins and Bitcoin, but it's PayPal. One day, yeah. It's PayPal. How we're gonna get all the winners your winnings. Thank you for all the kind words, AJ, and everybody. Absolutely. Cool. Yeah, if there's any issues with payment, you know, you have those ways to contact us. Absolutely. So yeah, we did go down for a week there. As we said, that was to upgrade our equipment. So nothing's down. We're absolutely good to go. So yeah, join us. We'll be posting our schedules on Discord as always, and we'll be back right to it as normal this upcoming week and on, you know? Absolutely.
Yeah,
so thank you all again. Drop us a line about anything, and we'll see you all next time.
See you guys.
Thanks, everyone.
Later.